Man, these chips with this hot sauce good than a motherfucker, bro.
Thank you. Alexis.
All right. Okay. All right. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, unfortunately, the meeting is now closed down. We need you guys to move to the door.
Just asked him how I did it. I got out the limo, grabbed the hand, went upstairs and fucked her.
Y'all should be ashamed of y'allself. Y'all black. Y'all are black.
It was at this moment that she knew she fucked up.
Ladies and gentlemen, unfortunately, the meeting is now closed down. We need you guys to move to the door.
It was at this moment that he knew he fucked up.
I wanna be the best in the game, invest in my name. Check no restraints, I'm obsessed with the pain. I ingest, I retain, assess and I change. Possessed by the thought I'll be free one day from society's restraints. Money, clout and fame, mud disease, a plague. We all love to hate, have to play the game, have to make a name. All our insecurities are on
this
display.
This is war with the enemy, think that it was meant to be. Living in a time where disease is on every screen. I won't let them fester me, I know most are festering. Negativity is a plague for the mentally weak. No mercy, all I got is working. Never stop searching, never quench the thirsty. I'm toxic and psychotic, with this logic you can't stop it. It's been chronic since I was a boy, so neurotic and chaotic.
I'm built to last with the webs I'm weaving. I could change the past with all I'm achieving. Got my foot on gas, never stop competing. If you break like glass, then this life's gonna eat and make mistakes real fast. Then you learn how to be.
I'm on it, I just wanna be iconic. Sipping on a gin and tonic, got me going off when I'm on this topic. If I ever play, I want it. You know that I'm always honest. Stay away from those who are toxic. Keep them out your face, no way, you don't want them.
Don't try to drain my energy. The enemy is everything. It's mentally, unhealthily spreading like a rare disease. But I won't let it get to me. I don't need your therapy. I can leave a legacy of leading by intensity. Come on, we could fight. Freedom is priceless, spread just like a virus, living in a crisis. Do you feel courageous? Do you seek greatness? Trust me, you can take it. Go on and take your aim.
I was built to last with the webs I'm weaving. I could change the past with all I'm achieving. Got my foot on gas, never stop competing. If you break like glass, then this life's gonna eat and make mistakes real fast. Then you learn how to beat them. If you
Late Night Crew. I do not want to violate anyone's rights this evening. That is not something that I would like to take part of. How are you guys doing? I'm the Shay Hall. How are you guys doing? Don't want to violate anyone's rights this evening. Say what's up to your boy. Got my Dalton PD shit on tonight. We in this motherfucker, bro. Laura was happening. Javon Barksdale. Chiefs, what up, though? Robert, Soul Man, William, Bob, Janice, what's happening? Carla, Rhonda, the motherfucking goat is in the building.
What's wrong with
you? What up, Hush? Davis, we in this thing. Babe, what up? Tracy, Charles, what the fuck is sleep? Sleep is for the weak. Smitty, what's happening? And the people that are tired. Lennox, what up? Pills, we in this thing. What's good, Boston? Kevin, what's happening, man? Wiz, what's happening, man? Steven, what up? Kiki, Janine, just me. What up, Scott? Natasha, what's happening? Sandy, I see you. I see you, but I don't see my lighter. I need my lighter. Leo, what's happening? Shout out to Colorado, Detroit, in the motherfucking building. I J-Dub, what's happening? What the fuck is going? What the fuck? What the fuck is going on? What is going on? Are we good? We good? You know what we got to do first. Stop playing, nigga. Don't even. Not today, nigga.
Basketball season has returned.
It's been a long time. Coming. It's life or death for me, man. But you know, there's no turning back now. This is what makes me. This is what I am.
Feel me?
You can hate me now.
QB.
But I won't stop now. Cause I can't stop now.
Braveheart.
You can hate me now.
Come on.
But I won't stop now. Cause I can't stop now. You can hate me now. You can hate me now.
Do it now. Do it now. Do it now. Don't hate me. Hate the money I see, clothes that I buy, ice that I wear, flows that I try. Close your eyes, picture me rolling, sixes, money folding, chickens, honeys that swollen, the riches, knives get in ya. Most critically acclaimed, Pulitzer, prize winner, best storyteller, thug narrator, my style's greater. Model data, big threat to a lot of you haters. Commentators, ringside, try, watching my paper, almost a decade, quite impressive. Most of the best is in the S's for this rap stuff that I stand for. Expanding more to the big screen, Bill Gates dreams, but it seems you'd rather see me in jail with state dreams. Want me off the scene fast, but good things last. Like your favorite MC, still making some mean cast. First rapper to bring a platinum black back to the projects. But you still wanna hate? Be my guest, I suggest.
Money is power. I got millions of dollars on salary.
Do it now.
You can hate me now.
I won't stop.
But I won't stop now.
I can't stop.
Cause I can't stop now.
You can
now.
Hate me.
You can hate me now.
Do it
I hate
now.
You too.
But I won't stop now.
Come on.
Come on.
Cause I can't stop now.
Come on.
You can hate me now.
You can hate
Do
me
it now.
Now.
You can hate me now.
Do it now. I told you, do it now.
Let's go.
You wanna hate me, then hate me. What can I do but keep getting money? Funny, I was just like you. I had to hustle hard, never give up until I made it. Now y'all saying that's a clever nothing to play with. Hate on me, I blew, but I'm the same OG. People warn me, when you on top, there's envy. Took my people out the hood, but you doubt on us. Saying we left the hood, but can't get it out of us. My bad, should I step on my shoes, give them to you? Here's my cars and my house, you can live in that too. Criticize when I float for the street. Hate my dress code, Gucci this, Fendi that. What you expect, yo? Nickname Esco, took this game to its threshold. Best flow, I bet the whole U.S. know. Try to make it like you the realest, but who the illest? Think we all know the answer to that, cause fearless, right? Do it now.
You can hate me now.
I won't stop.
But I won't stop now.
Now.
Can't stop.
Cause I can't stop now.
Do it
you
now.
You can hate me now.
I hate you too.
But I won't stop now.
You can hate me now.
Cause I can't stop now. You can hate me now.
You can hate
Do
me
it
now.
Now.
You can hate me now.
Do it now.
I like this. I like the way this feels.
Let's go.
It's a thin line between paper and hate. Friends and snakes, growing old or early grave, hell or the pearly gates. I was destined to come, predicted, blame God, he blew breath in my lungs. Second to none, wicked turned wives to widows. Through satin pillows, the desolate one. Took a little time to claim my spot. Chairman of the board until this game stopped, and I side with the Lord. Ride for the cause while driving out my doors. Plotting, I'm sure, to catch me with the to my jaws. Tried sticking me up, but I flipped on these ducks. Instead of me, ambulances were picking them up. People
mean.
Fear what they don't understand, hate what they can't conquer. Guess it's just the fury of man. Became a monster, on top of the world. Never falling, I'm as real as they come. From day one, forever balling. Come on. Won't stop.
stop, it won't stop. Never. Come on.
But I won't stop now. Cause I can't stop now. You can hate me now.
I hate you too.
But I won't stop now.
Come on.
Cause I can't stop now.
Hate me now.
You can hate me now.
You can hate me now.
You can hate me now.
I love you. I'm sorry, I said I love you.
I bet you wish you didn't blaspheme against the Lord in that video. I bet you wish that shit now. You can blaspheme now, but you won't stop now. You can blaspheme now. Don't think I forgot about that video, Hype Williams and Diddy. When Jay go down, I'm gonna get a noise complaint. Nigga, I cannot wait to go through that nigga's demonic catalog when it's his turn. That's the nigga with all the demonic music, for real. He be having 666 coded in his songs and shit like that. That's the devil. We heading to Dalton this weekend. We got Alexis Wilson's mother, Cara Wilson, in the building tomorrow afternoon. We have a special afternoon interview, so I'm not going to be staying all late tonight. I got to get my rest. We got a Cara Wilson interview early in the day tomorrow. Then we got a Dr. Cloud interview, and we got a Dalton party tomorrow. Tomorrow going to be litty. Charles, what up, kid? J-Mac, what's happening? You can hate me now. That's how you know Diddy is like a... Bro, just go back at all the Diddy shit and you'll start realizing Diddy has been a gatekeeper. Every hip-hop artist that's mattered has a song with Diddy. You can hate me now. That's what Tiffany's sitting around listening to right now. But I won't stop now. Bankrupt the town. They can hate me now. Dalton residents, let me say something to y'all niggas right quick. Do y'all niggas want to get ran over again? I'm just putting this out there. Y'all niggas need to get on the same page, bro. Rob, what's happening? It's been some shit going on with y'all niggas and I'm just about to watch how shit go play out. I plan on, you know, hollering at some motherfuckers. If you want to holler at your boy, you know, try to get in contact with me. Obviously, I'm going to be out in the streets. So if I missed you, it wasn't personal. Unless it was. Stella, what's happening? Orbs, what it do? Another thing people got to remember at this point. I mean, the feds are involved, so we'll see what the feds do. But again, we 10 months away from election. And in election terms, that ain't long at all. That ain't long at all. I got a clip that's really about to show y'all how bad Tiffany Henry's looking right now. Make sure y'all hit the like button. Make sure y'all hit the links to support the channel. Tomorrow, all donations going into the Village of Dalton. Somehow. No, I'm not sending them to Village Hall. Lacey goes there. I just I need everybody to also understand one more time for the record, I am not on nobody's side. I am an independent observer. Now, ain't nobody, I haven't had nothing happen yet, but like, you know, I'm letting you know now, I'm going to say something you don't agree with. And when I say it, I'm going to say it in a way that's going to piss you off. It's me. But as you've seen today, it is what it is. I'm not in this shit to beef, fight, none of this shit. I ain't even in it to make money. So why am I in it? I don't know. We here. That's all that matters. We here. That's all that matters. But if y'all want to see the type of trouble that Tiffany Hilliard is starting to face, oh boy.
Tactical nuke incoming!
Well, Darian, it always depends. It unfortunately, like, yeah, in a perfect world, you absolutely right. But unfortunately, the way this shit set up, just ain't that easy unless you the dope man. Unless you the dope man or you got bodies, the feds just don't come that fast. They just don't. But this will help the feds come.
Why can't we get in our public building to have meetings? Why are meetings being canceled? Why can't we have transparency what's going on with our tax dollars?
Residents of a Chicago suburb are revolting against their mayor. Tiffany Hilliard is the woman in charge of Dolton, Illinois. But allegations of corruption, assault, and even embezzlement are igniting calls for her resignation. A former employee suing Hilliard for wrongful termination spoke to us about her ordeal.
Della, what's happening? This is what I'm saying, like, unfortunately, you and the feds don't do shit when it's like they find something they could get you for. They still finish the book. Unfortunately, they just do. Now, understand, if they find, like, if they can even remotely really prove that she shot at Miss Stubbs' house and shit like that, then you talking the feds will swoop in real fast. Cause trust, when they finally do whatever they'll do. And the part that, if you Tiffany Hilliard, the longer it takes, the scarier it is for you. Everybody else kind of feel like the longer it takes, the more bullshit probably, the longer it takes, the more shit they got.
Deal last hour.
I was trying very hard to get paid. And
tomorrow's Friday.
I couldn't get anybody to respond to me, not to call, text, or email. And the pressure of not getting paid for so long actually had a very bad effect on me.
Co-anchor of Fox and Friends First, Carly Shimkus, and Fox News.
Not the Funkasaurus, nigga. You are now, they are now really starting to introduce the white people to you. First, when they talked about you the first time, it was like that overnight shit. Now you get more into the regular shit. Because like the out-of-pocket white people, like around the country, they really have not chimed in on this shit yet. They coming, nigga. I wish they wouldn't, because all they gonna do is help her turn around and go, oh, it's because I'm a black woman. No, bitch. It ain't.
Interview of Tyrus or here. Here's some headlines about the mayor, Carly. ABC saying Tiffany Hilliard vetoes investigation of herself amid corruption accusations. Dolton Bar sues, saying license not renewed because it didn't donate to the mayor. And narcissistic Democratic mayor accused by former assistant of putting makeup artists on town's payrolls.
Let's stop right there. Nigga, what you cannot do is quote one of your own sources in this list. I'm okay with you going ABC Chicago and then the Chicago Tribune. The third one can't be Fox News, nigga. You got to find something else, nigga. That's ridiculous.
So, yeah. Not happy there in Illinois.
If I were Mayor Henyard's friend, I would say don't veto the resolution looking into the investigation into your spending because that makes you look guilty.
Yeah, Mr. White. Yes, science.
Common fucking sense. Common fucking sense. I got a crazy question to ask y'all after this clip.
Just a little friendly advice, take it or leave it. But looking into her finances a little bit, she is not only the mayor of Dolton, she is also the county supervisor of Thornton Township. Two jobs. She makes nearly $300,000. She makes more money than the governor of Illinois.
Wow.
Governor Pritzker, yeah. The average income in Dolton is $24,000 a year. Mm. So you read one of those headlines there. One of the things she's accused of is using taxpayer money to pay for hair and makeup services for public appearances like this one. I mean, if that's true, and she has a lot of money and a lot of her constituents, the residents in the town that she serves, does not, that is a terrible thing. She seems like she likes a lot of attention. She's getting it now. She also has apparently gotten the attention of the FBI, and that may be some unwanted
attention. So she's saying the facts. On her side, she is saying she's got receipts to prove it. And
show them.
Vetoed the investigation. That's what I always do.
Yeah.
When I have everything to clear my name, yeah. I don't have to explain myself to you, Bill. Yeah. Look, this is what bothers me. Since she likes to group and the squad, they like to group and they say black people this and black. This is what bothers me as a black man because this is our representation.
Hello? This bothers you as what? Nah, Fox, no. This nigga can't speak for niggas. I'm Brodus Clay can't speak for niggas. Like I just want to be the one to put this out here. This nigga right here cannot speak before whatever he getting ready to say. I want to preface it with you don't speak for niggas. You don't speak for niggas. This nigga sitting up here looking like Fat Joe talking about, yeah, me as a black man. Nigga. Tiffany, they already starting to hit pieces, bro. Here they come. You wanted national attention. You about to get it, bitch. You wanted national attention. You get ready to get it, nigga. The motherfucking Funkasaurus. That's that nigga's real nickname. The Funkasaurus. Google the Funkasaurus and you're going to see a picture of this nigga. They think I'm lying.
Yeah. I'm the first this, I'm the equity. This is another situation where person of color gets in there and supposed to do all this great and they end up being super corrupt. We saw it in Chicago, we see it in New Orleans, we're just seeing it over and over again. And if you question them and you call them out, the first card they play is you're racist, you're coming after me. No, you're corrupt. The color of your skin is irrelevant, but they...
Well, you're strawmanning. I gotta defend Mayor Henyard here. It don't be nobody coming at her but niggas. It's like one white man, Dane Placco, and Dane Placco and Ben Bradley, the only two white men that come after her, bro.
I'm behind these walls, and it's starting to go back to the thing where every time I hear about a corrupt political or government official, I'm like, oh, please don't let it be. Because we all get judged for that.
Yeah.
And you look who the representation...
You ain't no... You mean to tell me... That you were embarrassed as a black man because it's... You wanted national coverage, bitch. Here it comes, because, nigga, they already own one, nigga. This nigga talking about, he watched TV talking about, oh, man, I hope it's not a black guy. Shut your bitch ass up, nigga. This This nigga is the highest yellow that can be possible, nigga, talking about, God, I hope it's not us. Us? Nigga, it ain't gonna be us if you outside, nigga. You gonna be just over on the other side of the street. Mm-mm-mm. Yeah. Caught the nigga coming out the store. Oh, he's a nigger now.
Right now, it's sad. And the fact that she's beat.
Yeah, he just shocked all of them. All of them sitting there right now like, you're black? Look how he leaned in like, you're black? Today? Say nigger. The N-word. You know what I mean. Say the N-word. You hear this, Molly? The Funkasaurus is a nigger. I mean a black man. African-American. What do you prefer to be called?
Those are investigations should tell you all you need to know.
We'll see how it turns out. Take us to California.
Well, so I want to know what you think about this. So there's a restaurant called Perch. It's in L.A. I've never been, but apparently it's very famous and it's a good place to go. They are adding a 4.5% security service charge to all guest checks for the cost of security personnel. And it says, as Perch is located on some.
Nigga, and then they just sidestepped your ass to talk about a security fee, nigga, in California. They just punched you in your face and kept that shit utterly moving, nigga. Jazzy, what's happening? Oh, my goodness. I can't believe they just sidestepped a bitch like that. That caught me off guard. I just knew it was more. They're like, yeah, fees. So shit you really want to hear about. Yeah, some fees. I've seen multiple pictures of all of y'all niggas, the plants, before the shit started. Y'all niggas was already in there, chilling. I know Tiffany wished they would have never hired that bitch to read that script. She fucked it all up. What's gonna happen to this meet Monday? I don't fucking know. I really don't fucking know. It's so many. I gotta parse what I say carefully because it's so much shit that I've learned today. I'm having like a level of sensory overload, bro. A level of sensory overload. She almost has to show. She need that bread, bro. She gotta have that fucking money, bro. I mean, I learned some shit about Almond Head today. I learned some shit about Stan Brown today. I found out what happened in that jail cell. Yeah. Allegedly. She's going to prison, okay? And I'm just trying to figure out who all's going with her at this point. Tiffany couldn't even look anybody in the fucking face at the meeting. I learned who Chief Lacey's old partner was today. Some of y'all niggas gotta let some other people talk at this next meeting. I'm just saying, bro. We've heard y'all. I don't mean no disrespect. No, if, now, if don't nobody else want to say shit, then get your black ass back up there. Yes, Hannibal had an excellent interview today. You definitely should check that shit out. I just want to know what Andrew Holmes' play is going to be. I really want to know that. Do I want to say this out loud? What was the purpose of him being in the basement Monday? I'll talk about that instead. The basement thing appears to have just been something that it turned that way. It turned that way. Like, I'm sure he came with the intent of sitting in his chair like, fuck you niggas. And they got there and saw it was fat. And then they heard the tone and then all the shit, so. I mean, we caught her on camera doing a secret squirrel meeting, and that's just what it is. I'm going to go have fun. I'm not, like I said, I'm not looking for trouble. But some of that shit going on there wild in the motherfucker, bro. But I'm trying to, it's something I want to say, but I don't really know how to, I'm trying to figure out how I can say it without causing the least amount of ruckus. Tomorrow when y'all come on the show, bro. Y'all can't be going at each other. I'm not going to allow that. If you got a grievance with the Henyard administration, cool. What this is not going to be is somewhere where you going to come and be like, this motherfucker over in Dolton ain't doing what they supposed to do with this nigga. No, we not doing that. We just not doing that. Some of y'all gotta stop starting shit too. I guess that's just the best way to put it. I want this weekend to be peaceful. Because today was a really crazy day for me. I'm still trying to process a lot of shit. And I need everybody to know, y'all not gonna wash all y'all sins on Tiffany. You got your own fight you gotta fight on some of the shit. You have your own fight you have to fight on some of the shit. Now, I do wanna ask a crazy question. And not to any of y'all. Can y'all excuse me for a moment? I wanna ask somebody a question right quick. This'll be brief. Roland Martin. Is it true that you've known Tiffany Henyard since she was 15? I'm just asking, buddy. You can tell me. Maybe I just pulled that out the air. I seem to be very good at just catching things out of the air. Have you known that bitch since she was 15? A simple yes or no would suffice. But you don't know nothing about none of the shit she had going. She's just some mayor in Dalton that you randomly interviewed that night. See, I figured somebody around you knew her. This is all alleged, you know what I mean? Well, actually, I'm not alleging anything. I'm just asking you. I've yet to allege anything, for the record. I have yet to allege a motherfucking thing. What's up with that, Roland? Hey, Roland. I didn't have enough time before I got to work tonight, but I want you to know I heard there's a 2019 interview of you interviewing some motherfuckers from Dalton. Don't let me find it. Roland, I'ma do you. Bro, I'ma tear that little one inch slick back up, nigga. If I get my hands on this for free. I'm gonna get my hands on it for free. If I get my hands on this, Tiffany, this is going to be one of your biggest L's. So much, in fact, that I'm not doing it until I come back home. I need, because I don't want it to get buried in the shuffle. No. Because, see, if I find the roll of shit, then do it like Saturday night, the next thing you know, the meat and the money. No. I'm thinking like Tuesday, Wednesday. Yeah, he interviewed her about a month ago and pretended he didn't know her. So all that little song and dance you did after the fact, I'm going to rip that shit apart, my nigga. So hopefully I'm just lying as always. And hopefully there's no tape, video. You don't know these motherfuckers, so obviously there isn't one. So, have you known her since she was 15? That's all I want to know. That's all I want to know. I heard that shit today, and I had to take a whole step back. I'm gonna need you to pay attention before you be trying to flag me down. Pay attention to what's going on. Nope, nobody's talking about her interview a month ago. That's why I said 2019. There's one thing we're going to do that's not Dolton tonight. Because I think we need to do this. And it's probably time sensitive. We got to watch this episode of Making the Band. The episode where them niggas was going to sign the contract. That shit Diddy said to them kids was downright scary. Downright scary. Diddy was trying to break them mentally, and it was actually kind of working. Awake, what's happening? I promise you, Roland, I don't think I've yet to even had to come back on any of this shit. Like, of this level, and say I was wrong. Because, like, even what I was saying today, I don't stand off of what I said. My whole thing is just, like, don't take me saying, like, I am not no political leader in this shit. So, that's the, like, y'all can't just decide when y'all gonna try to take and be like, oh, well, I don't have no influence, like, in Dolton like that, nigga. I don't. I'm really just kind of like some reprieve from it. I'm not in this space trying to be the savior. Because I'm not a savior, bro. I'm just a man. We had that. And we killed him. So. There's always that. I want you, hold on. I want you to see Arm Fisherman, man. Shout out to the Arm Fisherman, bro. Man, you gotta see the way he put together this motherfucking put together this damn video roasting these niggas at this fucking meeting.
Practical nuke incoming!
Pania, what's happening?
Due to credible threats, that is one of the reasons why this meeting was delayed. We had to rearrange some things, but we do have credible threats in reference to this meeting tonight.
You're a goddamn liar.
Unfortunately, if there are any outbursts, if there are any clapping or anything that is, or if we get another credible threat, the meeting will be closed.
Clapping is, did you even write this down before you got up there? This is why you ain't married, bro. You a police chief and you ain't married, man. That's alarming to me.
Oh, but baby.
All right, thank you so much for that. You have 2 minutes. You can stand to the podium. They're gonna call your name and you have 2 minutes to address this body. So you can start. Are you calling the names? Okay. So she'll call the name. You have 2 minutes. You go to that podium there and address this body. And it is public comment. Thank you.
I can feel it coming in the air tonight. Ooh, Lord.
Good evening. Mary Avant, resident of Dolton.
Motherfucker.
To all the department heads sitting on the...
And that jacket is bulletproof, too.
...dias for the last few meetings. You've decided to share your comments and your feelings. We don't want it. And we don't need it.
Emotional damage.
You are not allowed to answer any of the residents' concerns, so why would I hope or want to hear anything from you other? You don't know if you don't live here or pay taxes here, but your thoughts and concerns would be different if you did. Number two, Andrew Holmes, in his absence. Maybe he's in the back listening.
He is. He is. Trustee Holmes.
The nerve of you to sit in the seat as a trustee here with the allegations.
Now we've obtained a complaint filed with the Illinois Department of Human Rights in which one of Hinyard's aides on that trip accuses a trustee of a sexual encounter after she blacked out and had been un...
No, you didn't just have her mouthing.
Y'all should be ashamed of y'allself. Y'all black. Y'all are black.
Able to provide consent.
Hold the on. People put...
Yeah, nigga. I've seen this so many times. I know exactly what's going on in that shit.
Accuses a trustee of a sexual encounter after she blacked out and had been unable to provide consent.
And attacking on a black woman.
The people put you in the seat to serve as a trustee to the resident.
You should be ashamed of yourselves. Go ahead, Lacey.
Not to the mayor. You say you're an activist of law enforcement? Well, I was an officer in the trenches for 25 years. That meant doing the work, not talking the talk, not looking for a camera at every turn. I was locking people up, even took a bullet, all in the name of being a public servant.
Nigga, not you tapping your hands like, hurry up, bitch. This bitch just talked about taking a bullet, and this nigga looked like he didn't. First of all, nigga, why are you... This is illegal than a motherfucker. This nigga should not be standing here, bro. They got full control of this mic up there anyway, so it ain't like they need him there to move the mic. No, they don't. They'll just turn the mic off. This nigga's sitting here reading her shit.
Talk, not looking for a camera at every turn. I was locking people up, even took a bullet.
Bitch, you took a bullet? Did you see that nigga's eyes? That nigga like, bitch, stop lying. Watch that nigga's eyes flutter when she said she took a bullet. That nigga was not trying to hear that
doing
shit.
Doing the work, not talking the talk, not looking for a camera at every turn. I was locking people up, even took a bullet.
Bitch, what? So a nigga shot you.
Yes, that's why I wear this bulletproof coat now.
All in the name of being a public servant for the people.
Look, he about to laugh and she's like, this old bitch talking about she been shot.
In light of the allegations, I, as a resident of Dalton, former law enforcement officer and female, along with other Dalton residents, would like to see you display some integrity and step down pending the outcome of this investigation.
Yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah. I like this one.
And to our attorney, it is a disgrace that you will not explain to this body what the rules of the First Amendment are.
Yeah, Mr. White. Yes, science.
Total violation, so continue to get your check.
Damn.
All right. Next part.
One more time. I'm sorry, Madam Mayor.
Oh, go ahead.
One more time. I am.
One more outburst. Excuse me, Mayor. Sorry about that, Mayor. One more time. One more outburst. Do not make me stand up. One more outburst. Mara, do not come in here putting heart emojis, waving hands, angry faces, laughing faces. We've had a credible threat in any of these things that cause another credible threat. One more outburst. Sorry about that, Madam Mayor.
Clearing the room, okay? Okay, Ms. Avant, no, they don't. When it's a safety issue, it falls under the police department.
Right. When it's a safety issue, it falls on the police department. Stop putting them fucking emojis in the damn chat. This is a safety issue. Like, what the fuck is wrong with y'all? We talking about lives at stake. Nick, look, no. Look at that. No, look at them emojis. Those look like explosions. These are credible threats in this chat right now. And this shit has to cease. Look, one more outburst. Nah, just hand me the strap. They think I'm playing. One more outburst. Hand it here. One more outburst. Playing that shit. Shit is threatening.
Two fistfuls of butthurt cream, and you just apply it directly to the hurt area.
Good evening, residents. Good evening, Board of Trustees. The four of you all. I'm tired of our rules and regulations change every time we have a meeting, okay? First of all, it's not public comment because the ordinance have never, ever been changed. Correct me if I'm wrong, Trustee House.
What she's talking about, for those that don't know, I noticed this when I watched, when I've been watching the old board meetings. Here's something I noticed. It was not public comment. It was public questions. So you had like 3 minutes to ask questions. So like you would ask a question, then your time would stop and whoever you were addressing would answer it. So I would literally watch people sit there and be like, well, Trustee House, X, Y, and Z. And then Jason would stop the clock and then like answer him and shit. But then it got to the mayor. If people was asking questions of the mayor, bro, I watched the Zoom, right? Where this is when I knew where it was going with it. This was the culmination. I'm watching one of the Zoom ones. And some dude comes on. And he was like, I got the questions for you, Mayor. She was like, okay. This nigga read like 40 questions. First, he read like a couple. She was like, go ahead and read them all. He read them all. And then after he read 40 questions, she said, okay, thank you very much. Do I have a motion to adjourn the meeting? I was like, nigga, they just asked you 100 fucking questions. And you're not going to answer none of them? She didn't even acknowledge them fucking questions, nigga. It was literally like, she was told that them questions had to be read on record. That's like it. Because other than that, nigga, she was just like, all right, nigga, whatever. Thanks for tuning in. And so then it changed from that to now it's just public comment. That's why it was never like this where people just got up and just be cussing her out. That's all they got. That's all she left them. People would get up there and ask actual questions. They're not allowed to do that no more. They just allowed to make a statement. And then she tried to cut that down to 2 minutes.
You're not wrong.
Am I wrong?
You're not wrong.
Mary, I'm asking for...
No, it was worse than that, Mara. It was worse than that interview. It'd be like if the news people asked her a whole bunch of interview. Like, it'd be like if she sat down for that interview, made him ask her all the, or made her, or she made him ask her all the questions he had. And then at the very end of the interview go, all right, that was a great interview. You have a great day. But bitch, you didn't answer anything I asked.
Andrew Holmes to step down, which you shouldn't have never been in that seat in the first place because he never lived here. So stop blowing smoke up the residents behind, because this is ridiculous and I'm tired of it. Mayor, you might as well step down too. You know,
this nigga looked up there. Hey, you want me to check her? You want me to sock her? So is he, Mayor, you might as well step down. You want me to sock her? I'll beat her old ass, nigga, right now, nigga. Hey, you, what you want me to do? I'll shoot the shit out of this old bitch. Say word.
Because I'm tired of that, too. You know, this is a disgrace that you have done to this village.
Gotcha. Gotcha.
You thought that other fella was bad? No. This is...
Hold on, did you just head nod that you was going to hit her with the nightstick?
To this village.
Hit her ass with that nightstick.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Just tear her leg up with that nightstick, okay?
Bad. No.
Told you. He just got that motherfucking instruction. That's what he said when he put that mic up, nigga. Time. Yeah, we gonna beat your ass when you get outside. Don't even worry about it. Nah, don't worry about it.
This is 1,000 times worse than what he could ever be. You know, and they say that you the worst mayor in America. I agree.
Bitch, we gonna beat your ass. You see his mouth move? Bitch, we gonna beat your ass when you get outside. You think you can talk to my motherfucking boss like that, nigga? We gonna beat your old ass, nigga.
Than what he could ever be. You know, and they say that you the worst mayor in America. I agree.
Hey, time is up, bitch. It beat your ass when you get outside.
So.
Thank you. Good evening. I'm almost rendered speechless by that last public commenter. Some people are easy to please, I guess. but first of all, what's going on out there is ridiculous. I understand safety, and if there was a credible threat, as you say, Chief Lacey, there should have been a better plan in place. People should have been informed. People show up expecting to come to a public
meeting. Wait, did you expect Police Chief Lacey to do actual police work? The only police work he getting ready to do is have that nigga whoop your ass too. Look, bitch, didn't you just hear me tell that old bitch I was beating her ass for getting up here talking smart? Now you want to come up here talking smart? Bitch, we will beat your ass too. You got on a motherfucking Cubs shirt up here. We on the South Side, bitch. You heard what I said to Miss Stubbs, and now you want to come up here acting a fool? Your time's almost up.
And to have access. So this is the result of not having a structured plan in place for the credible threat that you said was warranted.
Special Officer Doofy.
People are frustrated. They want.
Chief Lacey, was that a picture of you with duck lips?
In place for the credible threat that you said was warranted.
Close enough.
Special Officer Doofy.
People are frustrated. They want answers. They want transparency. They want what these four trustees, Trustee Norwood, Trustee Tammy Brown, Trustee House.
What up, Dante?
Trustee Kiana Belcher and Clerk Keys want. And I'm appalled that the one trustee that's sitting there doesn't want the same thing. I mean, I don't even know how you can honor the seat that you were elected to.
Fuck.
It's a disgrace. It's a disgrace. In absentia, Andrew Holmes does need to step down. He's also a disgrace. It's only a matter of time before everything is brought to the forefront. And people will be satisfied at that point. People will be satisfied. They want change. They want better. We want better. So I just think that this is ridiculous. It's disrespectful. And to speak about safety, this is unsafe.
Fact.
I got pushed. Other people got pushed just trying to get into a public meeting. That's unsafe. So let's talk about everyone's safety, not just the mayor's. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Thelma. And I really, truly believe this has to end.
What?
I'm so disappointed in what's been happening in Dolton.
What?
Mayor, you need to step down.
Oh.
Because you have disgraced this village. You really have. Everybody up there need to go. We need to know what's happening with our money.
Money,
you gonna give me my money?
Where's
the money?
You need to address what happened in Vegas, and you have been silent. And it's not that.
Tiffany didn't even know who was in the room at the. Oh, Tiff, this was L, nigga. This is an L, bro.
It's not gonna fly. You know what happened in Vegas. You know what happened. And you will not, you should be addressing it, saying something to the residents about it. And we want to know where our money is at. We're tired of you just spending our money any type of way that you want to. It's not fair. It needs to go across the board. We didn't want that $1 million ice rink that none of the citizens can even take part of.
Fuck. Justice.
The only time is open is when you're given a function. That's not for the residents. You don't love the children. You kicked the little baby out of the Easter egg hunt. You don't.
Shit.
Love the children. And when you did that, that made me cry when I seen that baby cry like that. You are a disgrace.
Yeah, look down, nigga. Because you were, look down in shame, nigga.
Boo this man!
Boo!
You are. Anytime you would have your police officers kick a baby out like that, I don't care if you don't like the grandmother. But the fact that this baby was kicked out of that, it took away from all that you did. It took away. You are a disgrace. You done put black folks all the way back.
Shit.
And these officers, I'm ashamed of y'all because y'all.
She talking to you, nigga. Don't look over here at us, nigga. You was looking at her the whole time. Now she talking to 12 and you looking at me. Nigga, don't look at me, nigga. Look at her. Your bitch ass. She talking to you, nigga. She ain't talking to me.
Y'all are not honoring y'all badge the correct way. because y'all doing all the stuff that the man wants y'all to do. And it's not right. That's not how police officers are supposed to act. You're supposed to protect us. I'm afraid of you all. I'm afraid of the Dolton Police Department.
Right.
And y'all just don't get it. You really thought that after she said she's really afraid of the Dolton police, you thought that that was the perfect time for you to go, time's up. Y'all niggas just have no customer service skills whatsoever.
2 minutes are up.
Good evening, everybody. I don't normally speak, and I am going to hold my temper, but I'm going to say this. Mayor, you stood out on my street and you asked me when you knew I didn't vote for you to give you a chance because you had better things. The only things that you have done were for you. You didn't do anything for the residents. You did it for yourself. These people out here, you have all messed with our rights, constitutional rights, First Amendment. And I am totally hurt. And you have acted in such a despicable way that I will never forgive you. So I'm asking for your resignation, your administrator's resignation, and the unnamed, I don't know what to call him.
Bitch.
The trustee.
Andrew Holmes.
That's unacceptable. Everybody up there, your attitudes are totally unacceptable. There's been no work done. You haven't been over on our block. The street is split. There's water. People had floods in their basements, coming in their backyard, into their house. You've done nothing. You don't care about nobody but yourself. Thank you.
Facts! It's facts! It's not facts. These facts are not facts.
Okay, so.
Tactical nuke incoming!
My sister actually used...
Or them hoes are cheaped in a motherfucker.
My middle name. Because
I think it's more just that they cheat. That's why they be sounding distorted. They got the gains turned up all the... They don't...
She was afraid that you wouldn't let me speak. I'm Cara Wilson. I'm the mother of Alexis Wilson, killed by Dalton, Illinois police.
With the Dalton patrol officer hanging out the passenger side door of this minivan, the young motorist, 19-year-old Alexis Wilson of Homewood, flees the scene, a fast food restaurant on the 900 block of Sibley Boulevard.
At the time that my daughter was killed, Tiffany stood in front of a microphone much like this and said that she stood with the cops and they did do the right thing by killing my 19-year-old child. Not only did she not take those words back, she didn't offer her condolences. She's never said anything. The first thing she did was hire this group of security guards to surround her and PR. So the real reason Tiffany has security is hiding from accountability about what she said about Alexis Wilson when...
I mean, this is some shameful shit.
She was killed. Now, if you watch the coverage of this murder, these officers violated her rights, reached in her car, jumped in her car, and put 7 bullets in my child, 2 in her head and 5 down her side. And the next day, you guys tried to spin it like she did something. Watch the video. She did nothing to deserve this. And again, last time they brought up Alexis, she's doing what she does now. Look this way, look that way, every way, but at the person talking. You don't give a damn, and you never did, and you never acted like it. She called out a whole press conference to call my daughter a criminal, and Homewood Flossmore graduate with no criminal record. But Tiffany, you have one, because we use. your mugshot to protest in front of your house. And that's why you hid. That's why you have security. So let's tell the truth, which I know you're incapable of. I wouldn't trust this woman if she stood on a stack of Bibles and had her tongue notarized. Not a damn thing she says comes out her mouth is true.
Gas her up, Rabbi. Gas her up, nigga.
Thank you.
Say her name.
Alexis.
All right. Okay. All right.
I don't know what the fuck to do. I'm freaking, nigga, Chief Lacey freaking out. All right. All right. Nigga, ain't nobody's got up or nothing. This nigga freaking the fuck out.
Thank you.
Say her name.
Alexis.
All right. Okay. All right.
He all discombobulated, nigga. Turned the mic off. Turn it back on.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, unfortunately, the meeting is now closed down.
I told y'all niggas one more outburst and it was a wrap, nigga. As a matter of fact, everybody, hey, matter of fact, this shit over. Pack that shit up. Unplug them microphones. Wrap, hey, media, pack that shit up. It's over.
We need you guys to move to the door.
Hey, Lacey, shut your fat ass up, nigga. We can't cancel this shit.
Okay. Yeah, okay.
Okay, hey, real quick. I was wrong. Hey, y'all come back, you know what I mean? Get that rabbi nigga the fuck up out of here. He a rabbi. If he a rabbi, why is he doing threatening shit? Say her name. The way people threaten police officers now in public on camera and people cheer it on. Say her name.
Just, hey, Lieutenant, just the one that's making the ruckus. Just the one that's making the ruckus. Escort him out.
And let me reiterate, if it get out of
Wait. What is this?
And we will cancel the meeting and post it for another day because everybody's safety, we will not jeopardize. So,
okay, Tiffany. So, the trustees finally did what you wanted. You wanted to postpone it for another day. They agreed. What was wrong with that?
That's for the record. All right, go ahead.
Hello, everyone. My name is Nakisha Davis. I am the wife of murdered business owner Tavares Davis.
Justice for Tavares.
The unsolved murder of a South Suburban businessman and father.
Tavares Davis ran the Funnel Cake Man with his wife in Orland Park in Maryville, Indiana. He was shot and killed last August in Dalton. His family said he was found with no valuables on him, no car keys, no wallet or jewelry.
I'm here because it's been almost 2 years since my husband has been murdered. There have been suspects that have been identified. I've been getting the runaround from the Dalton Police Department. And I'm here because I'd like answers. If there have been suspects that have been identified, then I want to know why there has not been an arrest. You all posted on the media that there was an arrest. You all said something in a board meeting and everyone clapped and cheered, but you didn't say that you all released him. There were four individuals, including my husband, and my husband ended up being killed. So why hasn't someone been arrested in this case? I am a wife. I'm a mother of three children. My children and my family are suffering because of this loss. And Dalton Police, the detectives, have been sitting around twiddling their fingers on this case. This is hurtful. When I've been in contact, I've been asking questions. I've been in contact with the state's attorney's office. I'm pushing this case. I've had the Crime Stoppers come out.
What does this have to do with the trustees? This is what I'm saying, like, with Tiffany Henry, where it's like, bro, it's more substantial with her than just, like, they can't agree over politics.
to do additional work canvassing the neighborhood to assist the police. Nothing has been done. My husband, Tavares Edward Davis, deserves justice. Thank you.
What news are you guys with?
We're independent.
We got a platform.
I came out for you.
We got about 3,000 watching right now.
We got 2,500 people watching right now.
Okay. Hi, my name is Nikisha Davis, and I am the wife of slain entrepreneur, black entrepreneur Tavares. He was murdered August 2nd of 2022. The Dalton Police Department have not done anything. This has been 2 years. Wow. I've been asking questions. I've been seeking justice for my husband. I want justice for my husband. He deserves justice. He did not deserve to be killed and then nothing be done. They know the suspects that they've identified the suspects. They know who's involved. And nothing has been done. Why haven't these people been arrested? Why haven't there been charges? That's what I'm asking. I want charges. I want these people arrested. And I want them charged with my husband's murder. Four people involved, including my husband, three walk away, and one lays on the streets. Something's wrong with that. And they're able to walk free. They're able to be with their families. They're able to be with their kids. And my kids are suffering. I'm suffering because of the loss of my husband. I want justice for my husband. That's why I'm here today. I want justice. Justice for Tavares Davis, the funnel cake man. He deserves it.
Everybody put that in the chat. Hashtag justice for Tavares.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Funnel cake man. The funnel cake man. Thank you.
And you notice mainstream media isn't here to get any of your voices.
Yeah, call that shit out. Of course they not there to get no voices, nigga. For what? Y'all niggas is talking about shit they don't care about. Tavares? We don't give a shit. We care about Mayor Hinyard. Well, political shit with Mayor Hinyard. That type of shit, like people dying and shit. You know, we don't care. Shout out to the armed fisherman. It's bad business in these streets, bro. Cara will be in the building tomorrow. That's why I'm not staying all late tonight. Yeah, Cara will be here tomorrow. Dr. Scott will be here tomorrow. We partying tomorrow. There's a whole bunch of ish going on tomorrow. A whole bunch. Oh, you definitely got to pray for the victims. Definitely got to pray for the victims. It's crazy that there's such fallout. Just from fucking local board meetings. That's how crazy out of hand all this shit has gotten. I just don't understand how loss of life just doesn't make you put beef to the side. Like, loss of life. Loss of life. No? They be like, nah, man, I don't give a shit. She shouldn't have been acting stupid. And then, like, bro, the part that just bothers me the most is how dumb can you be to try to kick out Alexis Wilson's mama, bro, with all the shit going on. But Lacey's a fuck. He's just not smart, bro. He just ain't smart. You know what I'm about to do right quick? I'm going to do this shit live, fucking. I'm about to go grab a random board meeting, and I'm going to prove to you something. I'm going to grab a random board meeting and go to a park or go to where Tiffany's talking. And I guarantee she's going to say something outrageous. I'm going to just pick a random one. Let's see. All right, here we go. We're gonna go to the November 7th, 2022 regular board meeting. And let's just see when she speaks, if she says anything remotely problematic. Good night, Chris. Great to see you, brother, man. Damn, potato, bro. He making me want French fries. And that's why I'm like, when Firm Audit said, because Firm Audit even said that some of the police officers are actually nice to him. And that's enough to let me know they don't like Lacey. Because he does not strike me as the type that's really a nice guy to his officers. Like, and that's the thing that's going to, like, bring them down. Same thing with, like, Tiffany. It's just crazy that they end up being worse to their own people. You know what I mean? Like, the shit she be on with the trustees publicly, yeah, whatever. But behind closed doors, Tiffany probably treat them way worse than she treat the ops. People like that tend to treat their friends worse than they would treat the ops. That's just on some real shit. Good night, Bob. Good night, Richard. Great to see you. I wonder what, I mean, even if the trustees try to even do anything right now, like that's like the government is almost just at a total stalemate, just waiting to see what happens with Tiffany. It's like if they do anything right now, they come to the next meeting and they do something, pass something. She gonna veto it at the next meeting, and then they gonna have to come back the meeting after that to override the veto. 3 months. 3 fucking months. That's crazy. Do y'all think Andrew Holmes is going to step down? One for yes, two for no. As I'm queuing up this this regular board meeting that's opening in 2 seconds. The fuck is she dancing to? And nigga, where the fuck is the sound?
I'm losing my motherfucking mind, man.
All right, remember, when Jesus says yes, nobody can say no.
I'm losing my motherfucking mind, man.
Yo, the devil's in full effect.
I told you it wouldn't take long. I told you could pick a random one, nigga, and it don't take long. I've yet to watch one of these and be let down yet.
Hey, amen. It says yes. Thank you, DJ. All right, we was trying to wait for one more member, but the clerk just told me that she will not be attending. Is that correct? Yeah. Okay, so Jason's here now.
All right,
we can start our meeting. We do have a quorum. That's what we was waiting on.
Quorum. So did you just say a quorum?
She will not be attending. Is that correct? Yeah. Okay, so Jason's here now.
All right,
we can start our meeting. We do have a quorum. That's what we.
A quorum. A co-om. This bitch, I told you, you can pick a random one, nigga. She gonna fuck up some words. She gonna say some goofy shit. We have a co-om. Quorum. That's a Q-U, bitch.
He's waiting on. So let's begin. The attendant, is that correct? Yeah. Okay, so Jason's here now.
All right,
we can start our meeting. We do have a quorum. That's what we're waiting on. So let's begin.
Quorum. Hashtag C-O-A-M. A quorum. That's also acceptable. C-O-E-M is also acceptable. A quorum. We got a quorum. Clerk called the wrong. We got a quorum. So Jesus told her to use the clerk's debt to write $500 checks. Jesus told her to write even bigger checks with only her signature. Jesus told her to finance and told her and the finance director to do wire transfers. Yes. Except that wasn't Jesus that told her to do that.
Yo, the devil's in full effect.
Comb.
Again. First, I would like to call to order the regular meeting of the trustees at Village Hall. Today is November 7th, and the time is 6:42 p.m.
You 12 minutes late.
Clerk Key, please call her up.
Thank you that you said this.
To general announcements, I do want to make an announcement that says there was an error made on the agenda for number 15, which is executive session. We will not be having
the Park District President Cleo Jones and his family.
Fuck general discussion. You know what we need.
Okay. All right. That's it for me.
I can be recognized.
Karen Gordon is one of the people that provide the basis. And her bill is $800.
Head of
you have a car.
Not sure yet. No lot. Almost.
And 15539 Chicago Road. Is anybody here for the class H for the addresses I just announced? And Board of Trustees, would you guys like to make a motion for any of the class H? Is there a second?
Second.
It's been motioned and second for the Class A.
This property,
Phillips.
Honorable Mayor, trustees, Madam Clerk, department heads, and residents of Dalton, good evening. My name is Feroz Vohra, and I'm the owner of 15339 Chicago Road. We bought this property in a judicial sale from Cook County Tax. This property had a resolution passed 14 months ago. After the resolution was passed, we were not able to buy the property in a timely manner because there was a lien on the property. It took us almost 11 months to clean the lien. Now we actually own the property. So all we need to do is amend the resolution tonight. This resolution was already passed. So today we are amending the resolution because it took us longer to close on the property. So we don't have to go to the Cook County and pass two resolutions. Instead of two resolutions, Cook County can only pass one resolution and we can get the Class 8. Now, property at 715 East Sibley, the old Foot Locker building. We have a contract to buy it.
Y'all used to have a Foot Locker?
We had not bought it yet. And upon acquiring the property, the Foot Locker side of the portion will be a convenience store with no alcohol, no liquor, no beer, no wine, no gaming, no gambling, no lottery. My faith do not allow us to sell alcohol and lottery and gaming. And also there's a school right next door. So keeping that in mind, we're gonna have a clean operation, something comparable to 7-Eleven. Not 7-Eleven, but something similar to 7-Eleven.
When you talk like that, don't compare your store to 7-Eleven.
We have fresh sandwiches, fresh cut fruit.
Shay at latenightcrew.net. Hopefully it's in the description too.
Juice. And 6 to 10 convenience store. It's not gonna be 24 hours.
Yeah, that was literally where I was going, but I wanted to hear what this nigga was gonna say for some reason.
And next door, we're still looking for tenant, you know, where the beauty supply business used to be. We have some proposal for fast food, but we have enough fast food in Dalton, McDonald's, White Castle, Burger King, Wendy's. We got every single fast food on Sibley. So we're not sure yet upon acquiring it will be a fast food or not. We are open to ideas from the trustee and the ministries, you know, what product to business can be there, which can create job, sales tax revenues.
Nigga, are you up here trying to, you sound like you trying to get you a motherfucking government grant. And then 5 months from now, your motherfucking ass going to be sitting here talking about, good evening, trustees. I've yet to get paid. I just wanted to know. Oh, it's propaganda hour. Yeah, I'm always with propaganda hour.
The seniors and veterans.
This must be the mayor's report, nigga.
Right, for here and also the township. So again, if anybody are looking for employment, I can't keep announcing this enough.
Did you say if anybody are looking for employment? She didn't just say that.
We are hiring grant money left and right for here and also the township. So again, if anybody are looking for employment, I can't keep announcing this enough. We are.
If anybody are looking for this, she reads at a third grade level, nigga. Golly.
Grant money left and right for here and also the township. So again, if anybody are looking for employment, I can't keep announcing this enough. We are hiring for public works, especially with the snow season coming up. You know,
sister,
I'm a big advocate.
I'm about to start calling her Sister Odell, nigga. Sister Odell, nigga, she gonna always give you one.
And of course, this means you cannot have an able body in your home as relates to removing the snow. So the snow program is coming up. I pray that the snow really don't come until like December. But if you are interested or your baby is interested, have them come in and apply. Front desk, either Larry or Miss Linda, get an application. We will do interviews and we are also having them come and work now so they can learn how to utilize the equipment and be ready for the snow. Next, I'm gonna go with, I got three videos just to show y'all kind of what we've been up to. I'm going to start off with those first, and then I'll talk to you a little bit, and then it'll be time for citizens' address. The first video will be the roof and window video, and it's just to show you what it is that each one of those contractors have been doing and what they continue to do, even though they wasn't getting paid. This is what I'm trying to help the trustees understand why it was so important for us to make sure we stayed the course and made sure these contractors got their money, because this will stop due to the fact of non-payment from the Board of Trustees, not Mayor, Board of Trustees. Okay, so let's go ahead. So what you're looking at now is a complete tear off on a roof of a senior.
Allegedly. Tiffany, you can't be this stupid. We can't hear her, bro. Tell me y'all fixed more than one house. Burgundy Blue commentary in the building. What's happening? Tiffany is the worst film director, audio director. Like, she's just so bad. I didn't turn that lady down. It's just, you can't hear her. Damn, you so stupid.
Play that.
Nigga, if you don't want a executive producer that's singing in the videos, dancing, nigga, come to LNC. Nigga, she done showed like five propaganda videos, nigga. And it's another one, nigga. I didn't watch none of that shit, bitch. I skipped over all of it. Oh, you about to say something smart?
Jerking me 100 turkeys, but we give them two sides of bread.
Wait.
Thursday, make sure you come out for that. We're also having a turkey giveaway that will be turkey November 22nd, and that will be at 5 p.m. Anybody that's watching this or anybody that's in here, please call Carmen 708-297-6859 or send a text 708-297-6859, and you can sign up to receive a turkey. We also giving out food boxes, and then y'all know me, always.
It's them same fucking food boxes.
Get to cook meals. And anybody that needs a home cooked meal, if y'all know anybody in need, reach out to that same phone number. That same phone number so that we can bless somebody, family that's in need that cannot afford or cannot cook a meal for that day. We will supply them with a cooked turkey, which Kurt's Barbecue right there in South Holland will be jerking me 100 turkeys. We will give them two sides, a bread, and a dessert. So if y'all know anybody, they have to call. We will sign them up, but it's not for anybody. It's for someone that's truly, truly in need, because that don't mean I will.
AKA, none of you niggas is qualifying for it.
Cook your Thanksgiving dinner now. I just want to supply you with some type
be
of
love, I feel you.
And make sure that the babies are fed. also, I told you we're hiring.
If anybody are looking for a job,
to tell y'all can control this and control that. I don't understand it. And to Mayor Booker over in Maywood, kudos to you, because he called me and asked me to help him remove all kind of do.
Bitch, back when niggas were still listening,
he's responsible for paying for this before they start. You know, let me say this: the kids will not go without a tree. I'll be responsible for paying for the tree for Dalton to go up. Thank you. That's it. Yep.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, trustee. All right, go ahead.
How y'all?
Show me the receipt you paid for that tree, nigga. right now.
My name is Art, and I done came to like the last six or seven of these, and I had just wrote some things down. You know, I'm 29 years old, so I might be a kid to y'all, but it's pathetic how long it takes y'all to make decisions. Mm-hmm. It's crazy how the decisions of a few people can affect so many.
Nigga, are you reading off a script?
And as the next generation coming up after y'all, it's discouraging and it sets a bad example. Crabs in a barrel, foot on your community's neck, halting the redevelopment of your own community, all skin folk ain't kin folk, oppressing your own people. That's the stuff running through my mind when I done came here.
You see how much I've had to turn it down. I'm so used to these, to the lately. The ones back in the day, sound was just fine when wasn't nobody watching these motherfuckers. Sound was always just fine. It's the same microphone. It's the same system and everything, nigga. But all of a sudden, the audio sucks.
Different times. You can't point your finger at the system anymore and say our community is the way that it is because of the man. When y'all are up here disagreeing like this. Because as a unit, all you have done with your trustee position, since you got in the power of trustee, is fight and combat the mayor's redevelopment project.
How did I know you was about to be on the side of the mayor? How come anybody that speak for the mayor can't speak for her without reading off of a motherfucking script? That's all I be wanting to know. I ain't saying this nigga lying or nothing. I just want to know why all her people always got to read off a script. Nobody can speak from they soul.
The only money you've spent since you gotten the ability to spend taxpayers' money is spending taxpayers' money on them not having more resources. And suing the only person who is trying to bring them more resources. You had no problem spending money on the lawsuit to sue her, but won't release money for a kid's own. Y'all are single-handedly rejecting the redevelopment of a community that your residents and constituents have been begging you for months now. And I'm a kid, but I can count. The money you are rejecting.
Well, since you now in your 30s, how come I ain't seen you at none of these meetings, nigga?
Rejected may not be able to solve all of our problems, but it can definitely develop the foundation for us to be got up out of Dalton. And if kids are our future, then why are you rejecting projects that's going to keep kids off the streets? Y'all came together and instantly voted for a 7-Eleven's convenience store owned by another culture, but won't vote on an ice skating roller rink for our people.
You know, Rick is so wild and has went so far off the meter. It's shit that I can't even tell you on TV. I mean, you know, for the sake of our friendship, you know what I'm saying? I'm not even gonna bring it up, but trust me, he's went there. He has went where it's like, yo, Rick, man, what the fuck is wrong with you, man? You done took this shit too far. And his response is like this. There's no such place. Darkness, let's go to the abyss, nigga! I'm not with it, man. I don't wanna go to the abyss, man. You know what I'm saying? Rick wants to go to the abyss. In fact, he dwells in the abyss. Rick James dwells in the abyss, okay? And he wants company sometimes, you know? And for some reason, he likes to reach out for me. Whenever I'm around, when he wants to go there, he will reach out for me to try to take me to the abyss with him. And I'm not with it, man. I'm not with it. And that's when we end up, you know, tussling or whatever, you know what I'm saying?
Nigga, tell me you'll plant even harder, nigga. This nigga said we need that ice rink. That nigga said we need that ice rink, nigga. That's all I needed to hear, nigga. That was all I needed to hear. This nigga said we need that ice rink, nigga. They should have never gave you niggas money, bro. He slid that shit in. Y'all niggas is getting businesses and shit in here, and it's other motherfuckers that own businesses in here. Why the fuck is anybody in this city allowed to own a business outside of niggas? But y'all ain't gonna let us get an ice rink for her daughter. Make it make sense.
Y'all came together.
Yeah, that's how. Why? What's so funny? Like, why is it? Why'd that nigga laugh? Like, kayfabe. This nigga broke kayfabe, nigga. Fired.
Instantly voted for a 7-Eleven's convenience store that is owned by somebody outside.
Hold on. Did you just run that bar back like you at? This nigga had a freestyle. Don DeMarco, DeMarco, DeMarco. That nigga brought the bar back, nigga. Hold on. Let me bring that bar back.
Culture, but won't vote on an ice skating roller rink for our people. Y'all came together and instantly voted for a 7-Eleven's convenience store that is owned by somebody outside of our culture, but won't vote for something that will be owned by our people.
Would y'all be all right with white people sitting in some... Bro, that shit would go viral if it was some little white... It could be like 50 fucking white people in this town. And these 50 fucking white people go, why did you give a business to somebody black in our neighborhood? Nigga, they will shut that city down, nigga. I mean, I'm going to help. I am going to help, but nigga, that y'all gone. Them niggas like, yeah, nigga, y'all got these motherfucking Arabs up in here owning 7-Elevens and shit. The motherfuckers are stingy anyway. They don't never want to give me shit for free.
From my studies, there is no such thing as gentrification. I'm a landowner. If I buy land in my community, tear down and rebuild, that's called redevelopment. But if somebody outside of my community and my culture comes in my community...
Dolton just started getting niggas in the 80s. Do you really want to go down this path with me, bro? Dolton just started getting niggas in the 80s. So for y'all niggas act like y'all been empowering Dolton forever in a day, bro. Niggas just was allowed in Dolton in the 80s. I know this to be true.
Tear downs and rebuild, that's called gentrification. And that only happens if we allow it to.
Finale time.
Our super mayor has been trying to redevelop our community, and the whole time y'all have been pressing the button to stop her.
You lost your place?
All right.
It's 3 minute mark.
She was planting people in 2022, nigga.
Thank y'all.
Thank you.
Right on, Regina. I will definitely check that.
Hello. My name is Rashonda. I've been in...
Now the mic low already. She must be getting ready to say something.
A Dolton resident since 1992. So I've seen a change. When I was a kid here, we had a pool. It didn't state it. And they took it away. So we had nowhere to go, nothing to do. Now, as far as the grant money, you can imagine being in the house for that long, how our roof is. And it's very needed here. I have grandkids when it rains in my house.
Then why don't y'all get nowhere y'all
to play because now the whole basement is soaking wet. So I think it's very selfish not to approve something that our mayor is trying to do not.
You can't be asking for shit and calling niggas selfish at the same time when it's your responsibility to have a proper roof over your head, not the government. You want the government to pay for a literal roof. And if the government say no, you gonna call them niggas selfish. All right.
Not for one, but for many who can't afford such a thing as windows, Emerald. And I commend you, Mayor, all the projects coming.
Right, right. You commend the mayor for having you in a situation where you don't make enough money that you got to ask her to at least help you get a roof. Bro, this don't even remotely sound believable to me, but you can go off.
And up, you are bringing jobs to the young folks, which is very keep them off the streets, all the robbing and killing and all that. That's going to stop a lot of that. So I take my hat off to you, our very first young black male. And I just. See, you keep doing what you're doing, no matter what they saying, mm-hmm. your day will come. Okay. And so it is. Too.
Yeah, thank you.
I ain't see you there last night, the other night. This is a pro-Tiffany crowd. I love it.
Good evening, Dawson.
Good evening.
It's, I don't know. They've said a lot. I have a lot down that I was going to talk about it.
Time.
My predecessors have spoken about it. Number one is about the grant. Can you all please, after this meeting, just for the sake of the residents, find a means of getting together and approve these requests? It is important. Let's put all these acrimony aside. Let's work together now. I can see it looks like the wind is blowing now. It's blowing now.
Time.
Present Craig E. Lee Enterprise, which is. Hey, y'all doing today? My name is DeMarcus Crigley. I represent Crigley Elite Enterprise, which is my company that I started about maybe 5 years ago. I'm a general contractor. I'm licensed and bonded in Dolton as well. The reason I'm up here, I got a couple of different things quickly. Contractors should always be paid.
Not in Tiffany Hilliard's administration, nigga. In her administration, you never getting paid, nigga. Good night, Boston.
Especially with windows. Windows are custom ordered mm-hmm. windows. Mm-hmm. Those are paid by the contractor. Yep. So now with you all not voting for that, what you have done is put their money in jeopardy. Because these windows can't go in certain houses. When we come out, measure a window, measure a roof, everything that's ordered has been ordered. There's no, can you take these windows back? If a custom, if the contractor has ordered 200 windows and windows are not cheap, if a contractor is doing windows for $2,000, man, that is good because one window, one simple window, especially a bay window, could cost you $1,000. Up to $10,000. If somebody's doing a roof, depends on the square footage of a roof. I'm just going to say a 1,400 square foot roof. That's going to cost you about $15,000. For them to do it for $5,000 or $6,000, man, that's phenomenal. And, hey, I stand with you. You need my help with anything. I got you. I'll take care of that. Instead of bickering about different stuff, I want to see new ordinances created and not by just the mayor, because every ordinance that's coming up is by the mayor or Andrew Holmes as well.
Yeah, you can get on the trustees about not having new ordinances and shit like that. I'll give you that, cousin, all day long. But the part where you make sure to like try to single out Andrew Holmes all the nope, not going. You literally just asked this bitch to put you on.
Use your resources. That's what I learned. I went out this weekend with the mayor and trustee. Use your resources. Township and mayor, very powerful seats.
Right.
Use your resources so you can bring more business inside the Dolton. You get what I'm saying? And another thing is every event that I've ever shown up to, and I show up to a lot of events, and I'm going to make sure I show up to events, I don't see the trustees. I want to see the trustees. I don't care. If y'all getting into it, still show up. People are looking for you all.
Where was you at the other night?
That's all. I don't have no problem with it, neither one of y'all. All I'm saying is, let's come together. Let's do something for the community. I'm going to keep hollering every meeting that comes up here. I'm going to stand up. It's not because I want to be known. It's because it's for the community. That's my piece.
Hey, how you guys doing? My name is Jordan Murray. I'm just here to say that I'm proud of you guys for coming together and making some tough decisions, because a lot of y'all got a lot of animosity towards each other. And, you know, it's really hard to remove self out the way. But if you guys could just work on that and remove self out the way just so you could get something done for the people, because there's a lot of people here supporting Tiffany. And I got love for Tiffany, you know, Tiffany.
Nigga, you look like you don't know you don't even know them niggas sitting up their names. I'm gonna keep it a stack.
Tiffany has done a lot for the community. I work in a barbershop right here.
That was him? L.
142nd Chicago Road, and they talking. You know, the streets is talking. I heard a lot of good things, and I see a lot of good things, you know? And, like, I don't even know any of you guys like that, but I would like to have the same...
I mean, the cop is... Look at the cop, bro.
...emotion that I have for Tiffany, for you. You know what I mean?
Because... He's like, this nigga fried in the motherfucker.
Because I don't have any hate in my heart, and I wish everybody well. So, if you see her doing good, support her. Mm-hmm. You know? We got to come together as a unit, just like... everybody else. And you know, I'm jealous of other coaches because they come together, and I'm waiting on
you. Got a black man standing in a room full of black people in front of black people in power talking about he jealous of other cultures. Why do y'all always play this weak ass race card shit? It don't even be no good race card either.
Our time, but I feel like the time is now, and y'all got it. I appreciate it.
I mean, that's what I heard, Fresh. That's kind of what it sounded like to me.
Hi. I've been a resident for Dolton since 2017. When I first came here, I'm not going to lie, I was like, but the last 2 years, the last year especially, I've seen a reawakening, and I want to buy property here. First, I was like, I can't wait to save up my money because I'm leaving. You know what? I see houses and buildings everywhere where I can help our community. We want to buy property.
Where you stay? Where'd you buy your property at? It's 2024, so where y'all stay at? Hyde Park.
We put in for 3 or 4 properties. We can't get an answer because the attorney won't return the realtor's calls. $30,000, $40,000, $60,000. They're giving it back. They said, that's okay. We didn't get an answer. We need to know what's going on. And now I see. I don't know who Otis is, but he got to go. Okay, because if he's not going to answer no emails and stuff like that, all this other stuff y'all doing, wonderful and great. I love it.
Why do y'all all just so happen to have the exact complaints that Tiffany had? These don't even be sounding like regular fucking complaints. Like, she's sitting here talking about they buying property in Dolton, then all of a sudden she like, and Otis don't be answering his emails. Bitch, what?
See, I don't know who Otis is, but he got to go. Okay, because if he not going to answer no emails and stuff like that, all this other stuff y'all doing, wonderful.
Man, you don't
want
to make old Otis mad.
But y'all need to stop fighting like kids. All y'all need to stop. This cell phone thing and tell me what this is, tell me what that is. What y'all happened to the phones? Mm-hmm. What happened to the phones? Mm-hmm. Professional people live here that make money. We all work. Yeah. We are trying to make this community.
Did you just tell the trustees to call her phone?
Grow. Y'all need to stop. Y'all need to stop it. Everybody sees you. Mm-hmm. Ain't nobody just seeing Tiffany. Mm-hmm. They see all of y'all. Mm-hmm. Okay? So y'all need to stop.
Where are y'all niggas' YouTube channels at and all this shit? Why? I wish y'all niggas would really get on the national stage with this. If any of y'all niggas want to come on here as a Tiffany Henry supporter, come on through. This is the platform for you.
And I need that attorney to answer my email so I can buy a property so we can keep this thing moving.
So you talking about Odelson? So that was an Odelson diss too? Bitch, you wild.
My name is Laval Brooks. I've been living in Dalton since 93. And I'm really beginning to appreciate being here. But I wonder, when you all hear these things and hear how people feel, what do you all feel? You all are representing us and you can't even get along. I mean, to me, it's so simple. I'm telling my kids, don't give away your power. But you all give away your power. You can't even come together to do things for us. I would like to say, too, we've got a lot of young people in this area. When you all are doing contracts with those contractors, are you saying we got to bring some young people in so you all can teach them so that they can learn how to?
What fucking company would sign up for just to get a contract? We have to provide on-site training. Nigga, that don't even make no damn sense. You know the amount of companies that say, no, fucking forget it. We got to provide on-site training to niggas. No.
Do these things so you don't have to go out of the community to get people to do things. You can raise up people, right?
Thank you, Della. She's been there 30 fucking years and she's just now appreciating it. Gotcha.
Here, that's what you should be doing. If you bring in contractors in, they need to be teaching our young men how to do some things. That's what they need. Maybe we need a place, a school, like what used to be Washburn, where they can learn some skills. And then they don't have to, we don't have to worry about them taking our purses or breaking in our cars, because they can get some skills and take them where we would like to go. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Reggie Smith. I've been a resident of Dalton for over 30 years now. I've done more of my share of fighting for Dalton's residents. I ran for school board several times. I've been a coach out here. I've seen some of my old players, they're adults now with their own families. I'm encouraged and I'm saddened at the same time. It's great to have a young black sister as our mayor. These personal attacks, I don't know, okay, you can just disagree on policy, but you getting personal with each other, putting people's business out there, that's crazy. That is really crazy.
So how did you feel when Tiffany dropped that podcast? How'd that make you feel? I was just wondering.
You know, it's three sides to everything. My grandfather used to say this. There's three sides. We heard two sides. We're hearing the mayor's side. We're hearing the trustee sides. Then it's the third side, which is the truth. Right?
So they both liars? I hate when people say that, because the only way that there ain't three sides. There's just one side, the truth. That's it. There ain't no three sides. Literally, if it's the mayor's side and the trustee side and the truth, that means both them niggas are liars.
Now, I don't know what the truth is. Mr. House said we have a $2.8 million
right,
deficit. Tag. Is that correct? That's nothing to sneeze at. That's something major. How true is that? Why is that deficit there? I don't know. But that's something as residents.
Nigga, will you stop chewing that gum?
I want to find out. So right now, I'm on no one's side. I'm on Dalton's side. I'm on the village of Dalton's side. I'm on your side. Let's find out what's going on and support what we need to support. The warrants. You ran off a list of warrants that you didn't want to pay. My question is, how did you come to that determination with what you're going to pay and what you're not going to pay? I don't know if you can ask questions to the trustees. Can you answer that?
Yeah, it's public comment. So you just say your comments and
right.
After the meeting.
Because I don't want them to do, okay, well, I don't want you to do that because then they'll start asking
how do you determine what you're going to pay and what you're not going to pay? And then it's another thing. We have grants, as you said, $600,000 grant for this, grant for that. But the trustees are voting against the grant. So what's the logic behind that? I don't know. That's something I would like to ask you guys personally.
Okay.
But like I said, I'm for Dalton.
Thank you.
You for Tiffany, nigga. Nigga, y'all really did stack this fucking deck this time. Y'all stacked it more than normal.
$2,600 paid one.
You're not going to get residents. All right. Go ahead.
Ma'am. Hold on.
Who was that?
I motion.
Trustee Holmes, motion. Is there a second? Is there a second to pay the bills?
I have a separate motion, Mayor.
Hold on. You trying to slide the bill, ASD on the phone and shit? Y'all couldn't even get a second,
Trustee
nigga.
Trustee Norwood.
Aye.
Trustee Steve.
Aye.
Trustee Holmes.
No.
Trustee Belcher.
Aye.
All right.
Motion fails.
So residents, you get nothing.
This
board voted
one is
all right.
November 7, 2022.
Next, can I have a motion for AP warrant list for November 7, 2022? And just for the record, guys, this is the warrant list for this month. They just voted, and we did all that back and forth for the October bills. Now we on a new set of bills, which also includes, guess what? The windows and roofs. So let's see where they take us. All right. Is there a motion?
A motion.
Let me just tell you how cheap of a political trick this is. I'm going to give you guys a whole presentation about these windows and roofs that all y'all niggas ain't getting. But I'm not going to tell you the part where it's sandwiched in with a whole bunch of other shit you ain't going to want to pay for.
Who was that?
I motion.
Trustee Holmes, motion. Is there a second? Is there a second to pay the bills?
No.
I have a separate motion, Mayor.
Do you not want to second his motion to pay the bills?
No, I do not.
So you want to take out everybody again?
I have a separate motion, Mayor.
So you don't want to second this motion to pay the bills?
Do you not want to second his motion to pay the bills?
No, I do not.
So what? You want to take out everybody again?
I have a separate motion, Mayor.
Anybody want to second Trustee Holmes' motion to pay the bills?
The answer is no.
Nobody want a motion to pay the bills?
No.
All right. Again, y'all seeing it with y'all own two eyes. So, nobody want to pay the bills. They got their own hidden agenda. As you can see, everybody in cahoots together.
Hold on, trustee.
Everybody in cahoots together, and everybody got a plan on what they're going to take out and what you're not going to get, residents. All right. Go ahead. For lack of a second, your motion dies, Trustee Holmes. So here we go. Trustee House, what you got a motion?
Okay. Nope. November 7th warrant list corporate payments $2,267,791.62. Manual AP checks $30,000. Gross payroll October 7th, $396,363.42. Gross payroll October 21st. $446,521.66. Melanie Fitness Center register payments $1,244.32. Payroll Melanie Fitness October 7th, $428.05. Payroll Melanie Fitness October 21st, $428.05. Total payments on this register $3,142,777.12. Motion is to pay this, removing the following items.
Uh-oh.
Affordable party planners, $2,600, page one.
Affordable party planners.
Apostolic independent contractors, $5,133.34, page two. Country Lane gazebos, $90,000, page seven. Five Star, $319,600, page 11. J&J Newell, $198,710.04, page 13.
What?
JKCS, $20,000, page 13.
What?
Johnny Jefferson, $13,000, page 13. KNM Ventures, $42,875, what? Page 14. MBD Solutions, $19,500, page 15. Oak Construction, $4,000, page 17. Production Distribution, $73,287.09, page 18. Raul and Sons, $41,500, page 19. Rent a Christmas, $50,285.
What the fuck is Rent a Christmas? Hold on, $50,000 on Rent a Christmas? What the fuck is that? You can get everything in the rental center for $50,000. This is where the Christmas tree shit came from? Yes, it is. $50,000 on a rented Christmas tree, nigga. I'm so done.
19 cents, page 19. Rogers Roofing, $5,300, page 19. My motion is to pay the bills, removing the items as listed, and I will email this document momentarily to all residents. I would imagine there'll be a discussion. It'll be there before the discussion is concluded.
All right. Is there a second?
Second.
All right. It's been motion second. Any discussion? Okay, as always, I'm not gonna be belong, but can you? I won't be.
Bitch said, I'm not gonna be belong, nigga. I'm not gonna be belong, nigga. She is. You go through this every month. The answer is no, bitch. You can't have $50,000 for that Christmas tree. Stop asking, ho.
Be long because you guys just heard. All right, it's been motion belong. Second. Any
I'm not
discussion?
Be belong.
Okay, as always, I'm not gonna be belong, but can get out. I won't be long because you guys just heard from me a few minutes ago. It's the same song and dance. They removed, just so you clear, the trees that's been getting cut down. They removed all those vendors. They removed all the concrete work that's been getting done in the village of Dolton, including the police department, the fire department, public work area. They removed all that. They removed the windows and roof programs that the seniors and veterans was benefiting from. And guess what they just did? They removed the Christmas tree for the kids. How heartless can you possibly be? So I don't have a tree. So anybody watching this, please donate a tree to the village of Dolton so I can light up Greenwood for the babies, okay? Because they just removed the tree. So,
bitch, you make almost $400,000 a year at your other job. How about you just pay for that? This is why Andrew Holmes came and saved your ass. Now I realize why Andrew Holmes is like, nigga, I'll pay for the tree. I can't believe this fucking mayor just asked somebody to donate us a tree like we some fucking welfare village.
Again, pay attention to what they're doing, and they have no reason to remove any of this because all the things that they just removed was for you, residents, and it came from grant money, MFT funds, things of that nature.
Cap.
So pay attention to what this board is doing. Remember, they'll be at your door soon. Please call around.
You was talking tough a year ago. You don't got the same level of tough talk. I mean, you still be talking shit, but it ain't as tough as this.
Yep, we're getting a 30-foot tree.
What's happening, Noel?
And I'm paying with it through a grant.
So what's the problem? But again, because y'all didn't do it, y'all take things out. So moving forward,
Before we call the roll, I just had a couple questions. I pulled up the invoices through my viewpoint, but I was just wondering, it wasn't really clear. Production distribution photo sale. Production distribution photo sale.
Production distribution photo sale. So you was buying a whole bunch of fucking, basically they just like, you know, stock photos and shit.
$573,287.09.
$70,000 in stock photos?
I refer that to finance director Tangenique. So you know, if y'all have, and then just for the record, if y'all have questions about anything on the warrant list, because I don't put it together, you guys should reach out to the finance director or Janice, and they can answer any questions on there about any items that you may have. So we have Tangenique. And what's the line item? You want to read that to her again?
Yes, ma'am. Yep. 01-14-553.
Okay. And is there any more?
Yeah, I also have a JKCS Communication Services for $20,000.
Keith Face, bro, I don't even think he's ever written anything down in any of these meetings. I don't think he be reading anything from the meetings or nothing.
$10. I have a iHeart Media radio broadcast for $29.50. I was just wondering if she know what these things are.
Okay, so Tangenique, can you help her with those items? And where's Janice?
Lane Gazebo also, guys. I know you writing the list down, so I'm just to add that.
Gazebo, that was what Della was saying. That's the shit for the covers for the fucking her daughter ice rink.
Country Lane Gazebo's the pavilion for $90,000. Yep. Line item 45.
I know that one. That one's for the ice rink, and that's for the pavilion that will be placed over the ice arena. So I know.
$90,000 for your daughter ice rink.
No, that one.
Okay. Ice skating.
But the other ones is day-to-day operation stuff. So anyone can ask for Keith, Tangenique, where's Janice?
Production, distribution.
Is... I remember the days before he was impotent. Evil, hey, it's hard to get your dick hard when you evil.
Is streetlight repairs for residents.
So you hear about it all the time. Anytime you hear about any of them crazy, bro, I'm telling you, don't be surprised if some of these girls be like, yeah, and it got to a point Diddy couldn't even get his dick hard.
They've made complaints and they've repaired streetlights.
Say that again. You said streetlights?
Jazz, you said there is no pavilion?
Streetlights.
Right, Regina. I know that one. It's my daughter's shit.
Okay. So those are for streetlights, you stated.
Yeah, streetlights. new LED streetlights, too.
Got you. Okay, that's what I wanted to know.
Did y'all remove that
one? For resident complaints that the streets wasn't bright enough.
Hold on 1 minute, Keith. Did y'all remove that one?
Yes, that was on the list.
Are y'all willing to put it back?
Well, I got a couple questions. Maybe
I know, but I'm asking so we know.
Bro, why are you? For somebody that's always talking about they out of order, you're literally being out of order in the most literal sense ever. They're trying to get questions. They're asking questions and shit about this now. And you're going to like interrupt while they're trying to get an understanding about what these things are to basically be like, so you going to put it back in? Y'all took it out. You going to put it back in? Bitch, we asking questions, trying to figure out what the fuck we want to do about the shit with your goofy ass.
Anyone can ask for Keith, Tangenique, where's Janice?
Production, distribution is streetlight repairs for residents. So they've made complaints and they've repaired streetlights.
Say that again. You said streetlights?
Streetlights.
Okay. So those are for streetlights, you stated.
Yes, streetlights. Okay. New LED streetlights, too.
Got you. Okay, that's what I wanted to know.
Whoa! Did y'all remember that? For residents. No!
So those are for streetlights, you stated.
Yes, streetlights. Okay. New LED streetlights, too.
Where did the money go? Because they came, I know that the trustees ended up coming around to this and you niggas didn't pay for it. Because remember, we just heard, what, last month maybe, that they was talking about possibly coming to get them damn stop signs? We just heard about this.
Got you. Okay, that's what I wanted to know. Did y'all remove
for,
that
for resident complaints that the streets wasn't bright enough?
Hold on 1 minute. Keith, did y'all remove that one?
Yes, that was on the list.
Are y'all willing to put it back?
Well, I got a couple questions. Maybe
I am, but I'm asking so we don't have to go back to it. Are you willing to put that back in house
for the street lights or no? Oh, wait, trustee Bell, Norwood's and then consider.
Yeah, I'm just wondering. Like, I know I see.
Vape, just so you know, she makes the city pay for everything. Remember, we saw on receipts where she don't even be paying for her own coffee, nigga.
The streetlights, and I have the invoice in front of me. Keith, so you just said those are streetlights. It's just various streetlights throughout the neighborhood?
Yes, streetlight repairs.
Okay. Okay. And then she answered the pavilion question for me. She stated that's for the ice skating rink. What was JKCS Communication Services?
That's Public Relations.
Okay, public relations.
Public relations. So this the PR firm you was paying after the Alexis Wilson shit. Got you.
For the Village of Dawn. And what was the iHeartMedia radio broadcast? $29.50.
That was for promotion for our events for the year.
The answer is no.
Okay, she answered the rent of Christmas tree for the $50,000. Okay. That was it for me. All right. Thanks.
Would you like to know K&M Ventures and some of the other work that was being done, or you don't want to know?
Shut up, Keith. Ain't nobody got time for this gaslighting bullshit from you.
How about those?
Hold on. Let's see if I have that one on my list.
No?
Yeah, you go ahead.
Yes. Oh, yeah. K&M Ventures are the trees that have been cut. They've been pushed back. Residents who've had trees in the parkway that are dead, that we removed, tree removal.
Okay.
Tree removal for all the residents that, you know, have complaints about trees.
Just kidding. To be removed. Cuff soon. Sounds about right.
Okay.
Would you like to know about Johnny Jefferson?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Johnny Jefferson did the work on the fire station that one of our trustees came and cut a ribbon for. It was, we opened up a brand new firehouse that cut our lead time for our residents to receive proper medical assistance by,
she do not,
7 to 10 minutes. Cut everything in half. That was also for the residents. Would you like me to go through the rest of the list, or?
Yep, you might as well.
Okay. Five Star, I believe they did concrete work for the police department.
Nigga, I don't want to hear Keith lying ass.
Which one we can ask questions about it, so you don't pull out things that's actually getting done for the people.
Right, but baby, I know we get it late.
Well, while we're waiting on Stacey, I would like to mention that.
Be recognized.
Karen Gordon is one of the people that provide maintenance for our police department for years. And she does an amazing job cleaning the police department on a weekly basis. And her bill is $800. So, Stacey, I apologize. Go ahead.
Yeah, so Five Star also makes the repairs when water breaks are occurred in front of residents' houses, whether it's a curb or driveway. They are one of our vendors that makes the repairs. So some of those, some of that expense was due to water main breaks throughout the community.
All right, anything else? Oh, come on, Ron. They must took yours out too, huh?
Just a little clarification on the
anything about to say something.
I'm gonna get to her in one second. I want to be finished with you. So are you amending which one so we can,
what did you just say? You
back no in. I was currently
so I will amend adding some in, but I wanted to hear the full discussion.
Okay, go ahead, trustee Norbert. Which ones you want to amend back in?
No, I was done. I know he said he wanted to hear the full discussion, and trustee Belcher was about to say something.
I'm going
to
get to her in one second. I want to be finished with you. So are you amending which one so we can?
I see you, Kiana. She wildly disrespectful, nigga.
I'll go ahead and go over this list. He just told me now. You just come back to me.
Okay, trustee House, which ones you want to amend?
Well, Mayor, I wanted to hear the full discussion. There may be some other items, so I wanted to hear from Trustee Belcher, and then I'll.
Okay. Everybody went their way. Go ahead, Trustee.
I just have a quick question. The village administrator just said the Karen Gordon that was 800, you stated she was what?
That's a lady from the police department. She works in the police department. She cleans up.
Okay, so
the Karen and Victoria Diaz, both of them are the maintenance people for the police department.
Okay, so the misconception of information that's being, you keep saying go to my viewpoint. In my viewpoint, it says festival artist for $800. So how would we know that that's the cleaning person if it's put under festival artist? So obviously, if the information is not being inputted correctly, then how would we know what's being paid, who's being paid, how they being paid? Because looking at this right now in real live time, it says $800.
This is the shit that got your ass put on the floor.
$9.25, 2022, festival artist. So now we can hear somebody say it's the cleaning lady. How are we supposed to
know that? So how you supposed to know, Trustee, is absolutely by picking up a phone if Girl, you feel.
Call my phone.
Feel you have a question about something and it could have been cleared up by then.
Would so, I clear up something that's already
because,
in my view?
Because you guys basically did like a shotgun of taking mayor items out. If it said
a shotgun of taking mayor items out. Bitch, what the fuck does that mean? You did a shotgun of what?
Would I clear up something that's already
because,
in my view?
Because you guys basically did like a shotgun of taking mayor items out. If it said festival, remove it.
But if it's said, a cleaning person, hold on, why is it under festival?
If it said something that you guys didn't like, ice courts, paying for a roof or window, y'all took it out. That's all y'all attacked. Y'all only attacked things that I am doing currently.
But
you didn't
if
attack
it's a
nothing
cleaning
else.
Person, okay. Why would it be under festival?
What I'm saying, people right. do make mistakes. So if it do say that, I'm not looking at it. If it do say it that, it could have been cleared
I
up.
I mean, if it do say that, bitch, I'm not looking at it. Then pull it up, bitch. How you sitting here talking all this shit to me? I'm looking at the shit. You're not even looking at it.
Point, if you guys will ask questions.
It says invoice $800, house head, festival artist, Karen Dejanay Gordon.
Okay.
$800 picture. Let me guess what the picture was of. We all know.
And I just said, if it was a mistake, once again, you are a trustee. You could have picked up the
Why
phone
would
and
I pick
call.
It up and it's in
okay, I'm
it
done with it. Anything else, trustee? Anything else?
Can I address okay. that? Cleaning for Can the I police that, department.
Please? What was that?
Can I address Can that? In my viewpoint, Karen Diaz says janitorial services.
I just asked him, was it Karen Gordon? He said yes.
But that's why I don't listen to her.
The police
exactly
chief
what
said
I just
Karen
said.
Diaz. The police
Keith
chief
Freeman yes. just said Karen Gordon.
Okay, well now we got a clarity
well,
of
it's
what
Karen
it is.
Karen Diaz and it's janitorial service
and
she
correct.
Has history in
how he said it was $800.
So, the trustee's reading it in
I don't
the wrong
where
way.
What page is Karen Gordon on?
That's why I asked him
what page is Karen Gordon
what did
on?
You just say Karen Gordon? That's what Keith Freeman stated.
Where's what page is Karen Gordon on?
I'm not looking at the warrant list.
That's,
I'm looking
that's
at
on
my
the October
viewpoint.
List, which has already been voted.
Okay. Okay. Well, can we move forward? Can y'all tell me?
Can we just move forward without answering?
Which items we're going to allow back in the warrant list and which
ghost janitor on the ghost payroll?
J&J Newell, $198,710 on page 13. KNM Ventures, $42,875 page 14. Production distribution, $73,287.09 on page 18.
Okay, so now can you read into record the items that you are keeping out? Are you going to add the Christmas tree back?
$50,000 Christmas tree?
Can y'all add the Christmas tree back?
A $50,000 Christmas tree. And see, this is part where Dalton residents I know some of y'all, and this ain't saying the trustees are perfect. I'm not vouching for them. Not in the sense of they hold jobs, because I don't know what they hold jobs until to ever be able to vouch. But here's one thing I can tell you. How was it ever a point where Tiffany had a whole room of people clapping and shit for her? And then with all of this pro-Tiffany shit going on in here, these trustees see all this wrong and they got to try to figure out a way to stop this shit while not just being like, she's all the way wrong when everybody in the room's on her side. This is why now that people are showing up, they're able to be more vocal and do shit like what they did the other night. That's just my opinion. Like I said, that doesn't mean that there ain't nothing they could have done and there ain't more they should have done. I ain't saying that at all. But I just be noticing some of these memes where I'm like, nigga, how the fuck does the crowd ever... Bro, he's sitting here right now. Again, they talk about all these other things. Nigga, sitting here right now like, bitch, you want $50,000 for a fucking Christmas tree in this village? That's like a... Bro, she like Chicago ain't outstunting us this year. Yes, they are.
Okay, so now can you read into record the items that you are keeping out? Are you going to add the Christmas tree back?
No.
$50,000 Christmas tree?
Can y'all add the Christmas
tree back? Did the RFP go out for that?
Can y'all add the Christmas tree back?
So that was the three items I mentioned. Well, so I will read the revised list if that's okay.
That's
okay,
all I got before you read it, bitch.
Can you add the roof and windows back?
No.
I'm happy to read the revised items into the record.
So you want to add it? Okay.
Okay.
What about?
Bitch, this ain't a negotiation.
About trees. Can you pay the tree people that already cut the trees for the residents? Please.
Do you want me to read this list or no?
Yeah, but I want you to add those in so you don't have to. I know you do. Again.
We can
This is what I'm saying, Kiki. This is what I'm like. This motherfucker, like, she like, we get in the tree, we gonna try to compete with Chicago this year.
We can consider it for the next board meeting there.
But they gotta wait another month. They already waited 30 days, so they gotta wait another 30 days in order to get paid for something they already did.
Yes. Because I like how she words that shit. That's like me going right now over some nigga house and being like, let me have this PlayStation 5 and my wife is going to pay you for it. The nigga say, bet. I take the PlayStation and now this nigga's looking for the money and I'm looking at you like, so so that's how we handle things in our family now. We don't pay the debts we owed and we don't pay for services rendered to us. And my wife's sitting here looking like, nigga, why the fuck would you go over there and take this PlayStation from them? You didn't even ask if I had the money to give them or if I would have the money. You just set up this deal all on your own, expecting me to pay for it in the end. And then when I say no, you gonna try to guilt trip and make me the bad guy? Well, they've already rendered the services. Why would you do that? We didn't have the money. Bro, the gaslighting technique she used, bro.
We can consider it for the next board meeting, ma'am.
But they got to wait another month. They already waited 30 days. So they got to wait another 30 days in order to get paid for something they already did.
I think Trustee Belcher's point was there are vendors that have been waiting, and that's something that if we are sincerely interested,
yeah, and then exactly, then I call my mom and them and put them on speakerphone, frame the shit that way. Like the gaslighting levels to that. You don't want to mess up the family's name. You guys owe the money. You should just pay it. I seen a situation like this happen with my cousin before, right? So in Indianapolis, there's an outside suburb called Noblesville. So from like the west side of Indianapolis to Noblesville, that's like a 35, 40 minute drive. Okay. And Noblesville is like, as soon as you get out of the Indianapolis border, you're basically in Noblesville. Okay. Him and his girl get into an argument or whatever over the phone or whatever. Don't you know this bitch caught a taxi all the way out to Noblesville? I think they said that motherfucker was like $150, $175 bucks or some shit like that. This bitch go come in the crib talking shit to him and then talking about, well, the cab is outside waiting to be paid. Bitch, you thought I was about to pay $200 for you to come over here talking shit to me? Didn't ask nothing. Just hopped in the cab, got up there, then like the nigga, the cab outside went, nigga, that's Tiffany. That's the shit Tiffany be doing. Tiffany will order a cab, come to your fucking house, and tell you the cab is out there waiting to be paid. I ain't got no money for no cab. Oh, so that's what you do? You don't, you just don't, you getting cabs and you don't pay for them? Where they do that at? Like, the cab has to be paid. The cab was used. We used the services. But you didn't even ask. Why didn't you call my phone? Why the fuck would I call your phone and ask you if you're going to take a cab?
And then we can do better at the next meeting.
Right, but what I'm asking, trustee, is that those residents have been waiting over a decade to get those services, which we provided. So I'm asking for you to pay those vendors because they are still cutting down trees. They're still doing roof and window, but they need their money so they can continue because the winter is about to hit. If the winter hits, then certain people will not be able to get a roof tore off, windows replaced. So that's why I'm asking so they can keep going and don't have to stop.
Mayor, I understand your request. If there's a...
Again, bitch, for the 50th time, the answer's no.
Genuine interest. I will be happy to have a discussion as soon as tomorrow on what we need to do to make that happen faster.
Right. But if we do it tomorrow, if we talk about tomorrow, we can't vote on it until next month. Well, you should have came and hollered at me for real if you was really trying to get this passed.
Yeah, go ahead. Read yourself into the record.
So revised list, removal, affordable party planners, $2,600, page one, apostolic independent contractors, $5,133.34, country lane gazebos, $90,000, page seven, five star, $319,600, JKCS, $20,000, page 13, Johnny Jefferson, $13,000, page 13, MBD Solutions, $19,500, page 15. Oak Construction, $4,000, page 17. Raul and Sons, $41,500, page 19. Rent a Christmas, $50,000, $285.19 on page 19. My revised request is to approve the bills with the removal of those items stated, and I will update the list and send it in an email momentarily.
Okay, and what about affordable party plan? You don't want to amend hers? She'd do all the things for the residents as relates to...
I am happy to have that discussion. Nobody's... with you, Mayor.
Bitch, no.
Okay, is there a second?
What's the... they second? Already second.
All right, please call the roll.
So let me read this into record, even though I've already recorded this. This is approval of the AP warrant list. Trustee House has removed several items with the exceptions of three items, and they will be recorded in the minutes based on what he said. So I'm going to move forward with the vote. Trustee House.
Aye.
Aye.
Trustee Norwood.
Aye.
Trustee Steve.
Aye.
Trustee Holmes.
No.
Trustee Belcher.
Aye. Aye.
Motion passed to approve AP warrant list with the specific items that Trustee House read into record that should not be approved.
All right, thank you. Next on the agenda, and that's crazy. We've been here, what time? Oh my God, 8:37. We got three items on the agenda. Next is old business. Can I have a motion to approve Resolution number R22-4 open space land acquisition and development, the OSLET grant. As you know, I put this on agenda a couple meetings ago, and I'm constantly putting it on agenda because I was able to have them hold it up. And this was for the $600,000 to build a water park for the babies on Greenwood. I asked the Board of Trustees to support me so that
you try to build your daughter move forward with it. Too?
And all they had to do is agree so we can have a resolution, just like the previous grants that Ron Engineer just stated. They have to vote for a resolution, and I'm asking for their support once again so we don't miss out on the $600,000. Is there a motion?
A motion.
Is there a second? All right, there's a motion and second. Any discussion?
Mayor, okay. If I could be recognized.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, let me try to ease the tension ahead of time. My intention and desire is to pass this tonight. I do have a couple of questions. as we talk about the water, this is for a water park. How much does that cost the residents of the Village of Dalton?
It's $600,000 to build. You want Ron to get up and speak about it? I will allow him to do so.
No, I'm going to ask for something in a moment. Actually, we've been here long enough. I'll see if anybody else has a question. And then the only thing that I'm going to ask is, when we put this up originally, we asked for paperwork. We did get a significant amount of more additional paperwork prior to this meeting. But it was the funding opportunity. So I will ask if that grant
always
application
some type of trick
itself
before.
Outlines the budget, because I know it requested one, can be submitted. I'll follow Trustee Norwood's lead, either to the board or post online, so that way everybody has the information. But I am my vote at this time will be yes for this. If any, I will pause to see if anybody else has any discussion points. Thank you, Mayor.
Any more discussion? All right, call the roll.
Trustee House.
Goodness, think if I said no. I'm teasing. Yes, I.
Trustee, you see how easy it is to get to the motherfucker roll when she getting her way? When she ain't getting her way, she gonna ask 50 times. So you're not gonna vote my way? So you're not gonna do what I said? So you're not gonna do what I said? So you're not gonna do what I said? I'll vote for this. Go ahead, call the roll.
Norwood.
Aye.
Trustee Steve.
Aye.
Trustee Holmes.
Aye.
Trustee Belcher.
Present.
Motion passed.
Yeah, it costs $600 to build. That means it's just built. There's no operation cost in that at all.
You don't vote for a grant.
To approve. And can you please provide me with the Word version of this so that I can record the information into the resolution?
Okay.
As well as number it.
Okay. That's well, insane, thank Corey. You, residents. I guess y'all beat them up enough. They voted for the grant. So y'all getting the $600,000. Y'all will have y'all water park.
Do y'all have a water park?
All right, next is new business. Letter A, discussion and approval of ordinance 22-, amending Title 6, Chapter 5, Section 6-5-4-6 of the Village of Dalton Code of Ordinance regarding one-way roads. Is there a motion?
A motion.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
It's been a motion and second. Any discussion? I'm going to explain what it is, then everybody can just chime in. So the reason why myself and Trustee Holmes placed this on the agenda is because we have a lot of problems with a particular area, which is on the west side of town. It is Wentworth and Sibley. We just had a fatality there. Chief, correct me if I'm wrong. When was that? Last Wednesday? Mm-hmm. Last Wednesday. Every single person that exit right there always, and it's said to say, passes. They never make it. The traffic on Sibley are literally doing 50 to 90 miles an hour. So my job is to protect the residents and make sure we can figure out a way to make it safe. So I'm proposing to the board tonight to make this a one-way street. We did go by there. We checked it out. And you can only enter, but you cannot exit that way. You have to literally go all the way around to 148th Street and come back down. But my job is safety, so I'm asking the Board of Trustees to support us on this ordinance and making Wentworth a one-way street. Any discussion?
Is Wentworth the only street, Mayor?
Say again?
Is Wentworth the only street that you're requesting?
Correct, because the other streets go east and west.
Okay. So this is the only way when you go to the park, it's like a dead end. So Wentworth is right there where the liquor store is at. I don't know if anybody's familiar with the area right there, but it's down there by the McDonald's. But it's the, before you get to the overpass, it's the little street. It's called Wentworth, right next to the liquor store. Everyone exits and they inches and inches out a little bit. And by the time they get halfway out, someone hits them. Everyone dies there, and my job is to save lives. Andrew's job is to save lives.
I mean, we saw, bro.
He decided to come up with this ordinance, put it on the.
Bitch, we saw the roads right outside this building. That, for me to see the roads that you go to go to that motherfucker, lets me know what it looked like, bro.
Agenda and try to figure out how we can alleviate people from coming that way and just going to a light. It's a light right there on the south, so all you have to do is exit out of their homes and go the opposite way to 148 and then come over to the light. So that's the reason why we created this ordinance. Any more discussion? Okay, please call the roll.
Trustee House.
Aye.
Trustee Norwood.
Aye.
Trustee Steve.
Aye.
Trustee Holmes.
Aye.
Trustee Belcher.
Aye.
Motion passed.
Wait a minute. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Do you think this makes them want to vote your way? Like, she's not even good at this shit. Like, even when they vote her way, she shamed them.
My first unified vote. No, God. Thank you, boy. Okay, now the next one is letter B. Can I have a motion for a discussion and approval of ordinance number 22-, creating a new section 3-1-1? No.
So wait, did the trustees just create an ordinance? I thought they didn't do that.
3-1-14.1. Of Title 3, Chapter 1 of the Village of Dolton Code of Ordinance related to business and licenses and public safety threats for the Village of Dolton. Is there a motion?
Motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
Okay, it's been motioned and second. Any discussion? And I'll explain to you guys what this is. A lot of times people call us, it can be midday, a lot of time, I know myself and Trustee Holmes get the calls late at night, and someone...
For what? Y'all sell dope? The fuck niggas hitting you late at night for?
...has passed or shooting has occurred. Unfortunately, we have to put laws in place.
That's what I'm saying, Della. I've had to listen to these department heads over and over and over tell me that they ain't never created a single ordinance. Not one. I just watched them do one.
It's to protect the residents and also the people that's passing by. We put this ordinance on the agenda, myself and the Trustee Holmes, because we've been getting too many crying moms, crying parents as relates to their
babies.
Either you
sell dope or you sell pussy. That's the only reason you... Fielding phone calls late. Yeah, me and Andrew Holmes get phone calls late at night. Yeah, that's what got y'all fucked up in Vegas, allegedly.
Being either gunned down, drive-by, shootings throughout our community. One in particular I know Chief Collins spoke on was the Maxwells right there on Sibley. I know last board meeting, the mom, she was here and she was asking us to do something. Oh, there she go. Hey. She was asking us to do something about Maxwell. So I'm just letting you know, we put on an agenda. We're doing something about Maxwell's right now. We're putting a law in place that allows them the opportunity to get security when it's a shooting. When a shooting occurs, you have to get armed security. You can no longer have a business without a patrol person, like a police officer there, and making sure that people that's entering and exiting out of your business are safe. So that's what this ordinance entails. Currently now, the people that house this same ordinance is the city of Chicago. After something happens, like a shooting at a business in Chicago, they go through the same steps that's outlined in this ordinance. And that's what we are requiring for our businesses here in town. We did have that business meeting like Chief did discuss, and we did talk to them about we're going to make a lot of changes in this being one. So when something happens on
Keith is over this shit.
property, even though I know, I hear you business owners, you say it's not your fault, but it's the crowd that you attract, whether it's a club, a restaurant, or things that's open 24 hours, such as Maxwell, where people sit there and sit in the lot for hours when they really should be going home. So if something happened on your lot, you have to follow this ordinance. So I just wanted to give clarity to it. Do any board member have any comments, suggestions, concerns?
Yeah, might be recognized, man.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, this, you know, if we had or the business had been proactive in this, you know, I'm not saying maybe your baby life would have been saved, but, you know, it's up to us to put these laws in. They got to follow the protocols. They got to have updated cameras. They got to have security there. You know, we have a police department. They were roaming. They're answering calls. But if these businesses have armed security that are licensed by the state, we can save the next individual. And I'm glad this mother has been staying on top of this. We had a meeting with all the businesses owners east of...
Armed security does not sound safe to me.
On the east side, we're working our way to the west side. So we're going to be meeting with our chief and the business owners all throughout the village of Dolton for our safety issue, because...
So... Jazzy said, fuck that fucking ordinance on that. She said, making Wentworth a one-way would cause residents on Riverside Drive and 148th Place to drive way out of their way to get back to the main road. Oh my goodness. Probably swinging past some businesses she fuck with.
You know, it's wintertime. People standing around at the stores, food for less and everything. We don't know what their intentions are. They may be hungry, but still, we don't know what their intentions are, or someone else comes up there, and then all of a sudden, somebody's purse gets snatched, or there's a shooting. So we're trying to be proactive and prevent this. So hopefully, we can pass this and get this through.
What bitches are standing out in the parking lot at 3 in the morning with their purses in a snatch position?
All right. Any more discussion? All right, cholera.
Trustee House.
Aye.
Trustee.
You see, I knew it, Jazzy. That's the only thing. As soon as you tell me that leads, they bust out a dead end and it leads all the way a long way, I'm like, I bet it swing past some shit that's hers. Or she, or that fuck with her.
Norwood.
Aye.
Trustee Steve.
Aye.
Trustee Holmes.
Aye.
And Trustee Belcher.
Aye.
Motion passed.
All right. Yeah.
Again, Mayor,
it wasn't a dead end either.
On your team is preparing these. If they can please email me electronic version so I can properly record them.
Okay, I have Keith email you, and then attorney here email as well. Next on the agenda is C, discussion of class 8 for Dunkin' Donuts, 1136. Sibley, and discussion of class 8 for Dunkin' Donuts, 715 East Sibley and 15539 Chicago Road. Is anybody here for the class 8 for the addresses I just announced? And Board of Trustees, would you guys like to make a motion for any of
Honorable Mayor?
All right. I think we had like 3 minutes of comment left in at that one nigga. Yeah, I don't think we've seen her. We didn't see him either. We didn't see her. Yeah, this is the last nigga we saw. And I'm for Dalton.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Gloria Johnson, and I'm the founder and CEO of a nonprofit organization, Young Adult Living Assistance, known as YALA. I came tonight with a small presentation, but for the sake of time...
Did you see the clerk request an electronic copy of the mayor's report 2 years ago? Oh, my.
Just present to you, Mayor, the vision and mission of who YALA is. But to put a twist on tonight, I've sat and listened to everything being taken away. For the last 2 years, Young Adult Living Assistance has given back a toy drive to the communities less fortunate. So 2020, it was in Morgan Park. 2021, it was in West Pullman. This year, we wanted to give back to Dalton. So my reason standing here was just really for permission to give back on Sunday, December 18th, but by using the lot on Greenwood to set up and create the toy drive. So, and it's open to the public. Anyone with children can come through and receive a gift until they are exhausted.
Okay. If you could see Keith, I don't know where he walked to, but when he come back up, Keith Freeman, he's the village administrator.
Okay.
Nigga, that's, I heard that's a death sentence. Whenever does she send you to Keith, nigga, that's basically a wrap.
That's okay. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Hit that like button if you have not already.
Resident of Dalton, Mayor, trustees, my name is Demetrius Walker. Been here a long time in this village. A lot of you guys know me up here. Mayor, you know me personally, right? House, you know me personally. Brittany, Steve, Holmes, Keona.
Did you just call her Keona? And I wish men would stop doing this to their head. Whoever started this whole half my head gonna be dreads, the other half shaved shit. This nigga look like Keegan Michael Key. Keona. Nigga, like, and he said that shit with confidence too, nigga. Keona. Deshaun.
Yeah. Mayor, you know me personally, right?
And that's a problem.
House, you know me personally. Brittany. Steve. Holmes. Keona.
This nigga want me to take this nigga seriously that he know everything that's going on, this motherfucker. He don't know her name is Keona.
Up here. Mayor, you know me personally, right? House, you know me personally.
See, Mayor, pay attention. House.
Brittany.
Then all of a sudden, Brittany.
Steve.
Then oh, back Holmes. To last name, Steve sure. Holmes. So he just blatantly disrespects Brittany and Keona.
Kimono. We went through a lot.
Kimono. In kimono.
A lot of fights, a lot of battles. Tiffin, we used to talk. We had good conversation back in the days with Mayor. All the nonsense just steady flowed over. You guys asked us to support you. You asked us to help each and every last one of you to gain unison, right? To unite for growth, to get something positive into deliverance, right? I see a lot of confusion.
Did you just call that nigga Forehead Locks? Instead of Goldilocks, this nigga's Forehead Locks. I mean, nigga, you need to do something with all that new growth on the side, too. That shit's not cute.
Right? It's a lot of...
He's in a Rasta mullet.
High-power positioning type of mannerism.
That new is growth in the front, party in the back.
Taking place, right? Nobody wants to work together. When we were formed as a team together, you came to Tiffany, you asked for our support. The whole street team to support you as mayor, to work together to be transparent. I love what you're
the
doing.
Fuck right? The mullet.
I'm not gonna lie to you. You have done a lot of beautiful things for this community. I don't take that back from you. But your transparency skills with working with the trustees, we gotta work on those things. Trustees, guys, we're in a community of residents that wants what they want.
The part that about what the part that's going to fuck y'all up is when y'all realize all them dreads is a man unit. On the sides, that's his real hair. And then he just slapped that fucking man unit on, nigga. He's like, shit, I'm ready. That's a whole ass man unit, nigga. You see where it's real. This is real hair right here. And then you see the unit. Does that look like the same scalp to you? This nigga got a dread unit, nigga. Dread unit.
Want, it's not about what the mayor wants. It's about what us as residents want. We're business owners. We're residents here. We have kids in this community that needs positive sources to look up to, right?
See, so, I told you there ain't no natural movement to that motherfucker. That is a man unit.
We're coming alleged. In with all this bickering, right? We're talking about grants. We're talking about finances. We're talking.
Thank you. Thank you. Top bump right there.
Oh
I can't unsee it now either. Shout out Jazzy. I can't unsee that shit now either.
Talking about business. This would be a business platform, not an emotional family feud type racket.
It's all
about business. It's about budgets. It's about costs. And it's about effectively setting those things to move forward, right? So if we have grants, if we have things that are available to us, like funds, money, isn't it transparency that we are told how much money we have? Where does that money come from?
Nigga, I ain't heard shit you said this whole time. I just been staring at your fucking head. I can't lie. I so wish I was lying, nigga. Like, I ain't heard shit this nigga said. I just been looking in awe at this fucking shit on his head, bro. Oh, shit. Tiffany, you gotta get better plants, nigga.
What is being set? Because grants are very tricky things. They're wonderful things, yes. They can absolutely help. But if that grant is not funded for whatever purpose that can happen, what does that money go back to? What does that problem take place to? I love the idea of the skating rink. All of it is beautiful. But the economic part of it is, what is going to be the financial responsibility?
When the whole crew is stupid, nigga.
After it's built, it's running on the taxpayer heads and the operation of that facility, right? So we have to accommodate all these things as a business idea and stop everybody thinking emotional, right? And let's come with some transparency to the village, to the residents, of why we're coming up with such wonderful things of growth, the economic development growth, how we're coming up with the ideas of trustees, why you don't want to work the mayor, why you do. Let's get transparency, guys. Let's stop with the argument.
Man, you corny!
Let's move forward. Thank you.
Hi, I am, without giving my name, but I've been... resident of Dolton for over 25 years, I want to say. And I do want to say that I'm on that street that you guys just paved right around the corner from Roosevelt. So that's the first time I've ever seen anything. I've been complaining about that street on Roosevelt for a long time. So I really commend you guys together, not just Mayor Tiffany, but all of you guys for being a part of that. The only person on the trustee that I personally know that I've dealt with was Holmes.
And let me guess, you're not married, are you?
Trustee Holmes. And that's because of what he dealt for my 90-something-year-old parents, in-laws. And
okay, you married.
I reach out to him certain times when I can't get through. But one thing I've done, this is my first time ever coming to this meeting. I've been to the conversation with the mayor, but it's my first time coming to these meetings. And people in my community have warned me about these meetings. And it breaks my heart, absolutely breaks my heart. But what I want to say is this, what I heard that's clear is that the guy that just spoke that talked about transparency, that is so key.
I mean, this shit is hilarious.
If we don't see the transparency on the website that someone, I'm not sure who was it that mentioned it, that's gonna tell me something. And it may tell a lot of us something. What? But it's not on Tiffany. I know it's not.
So what if Tiffany takes them out of my viewpoint altogether? Is it on Tiffany then? Shut the fuck up. It's not on Tiffany. Shut up, bitch.
It's not pointed at her at all.
She's the leader. That, bro, again. I'm just telling you. In the corporate world, this is why men be having a problem with women. And bro, they even did a survey. Women don't like working for women. Because for whatever reason, these chicks that get in these boss positions don't want the bad with it. So when shit go left, somehow Tiffany gets to blame the trustees. And this ain't all women. This is women that be like Tiffany and these bitches that be vouching for this shit. You wouldn't be sitting, if Jason House is the fucking mayor, you wouldn't be sitting there saying that he gets to blame the women. You, bro, literally all the shit gonna be his fault. You gonna sit here, she's the mayor. That's the one thing where it's like, okay, so if you telling me that paving that road was a good thing or whatever, then she can have that. She got that done during her term. So yeah, she can have that. But shit that don't pop off, you gonna sit here and be like, nah, it ain't her fault at all. And then you even openly admit your bias. How does she openly admit her bias? She lets you know she doesn't know for sure, but she do know that it's not Tiffany's fault. How the fuck do you know? You just said you don't know anything except that. Which, how can you know nothing but know that? You gotta get some better plants, nigga.
But I'm just saying the transparency, and I do know that there has to be an order in which things are getting paid. It breaks my heart to know that the one thing that was granted was this roof and, you know, the windows and all of that. And to know that that's not happening. And it's
see, and again, this is the gaslighting of that roofs and windows shit. Did y'all say, is everybody in Dalton getting a new roof and windows? No. We all know the answer is no. But she's trying to sell it like that, though. Saying it's always her favorite sales tactic. It's the same thing she did with the skating rink. Yes, I want this skating rink for the community, for us, the community, for us, the community, for us. Get that motherfucker, name it after her daughter, and it's only open when they go. Same shit now. Y'all vote on them motherfucking roofs and windows. And then the trustees will get torched. The right thing right here is just to take that L. No, the answer is no. Because you know how bad it'd be if you vote yes. And then all these people in Dalton ain't getting no windows and shit done.
Because of a process, perhaps, but trust, but the transparency, I think, is key. If we all have that, if you guys all have that, and we can see in the village, we can see it on the website, and we can see that Tiffany's getting what she's want, and you guys are getting what you need, that's going to tell us something, because we don't know
what's going on. How come she get what she want, but we only get what we need? That sounds a bit off.
What's going on behind closed doors? But we'll know if you put it on the website.
Cap.
Good evening, everyone. Mayor, trustees, clerk. I agree with Demetrius. I agree with the young lady that just spoke. Trustee Norwood made the best point I've heard in a long time, because there's no side here. There's us, the residents. But if I don't know what the grant says, you say one thing, you say something else, then I'm going to side with the one that seems to be in my favor. If these documents are put on the website, then there's no lie here and no lie here.
Uh-oh.
I've asked personally for 4 months for documents that I was told I could get. I haven't got them. I don't think I'm going to get them in the 5th and 6th month either.
Uh-oh.
But while we applauding and jumping up and down and all happy, why don't you want to know the truth for yourself?
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
All of us can read. Because if I find out I get a roof and some windows with that money that I wasn't supposed to get and you ask me for some money back, you got a problem. So
uh-oh. Right. You telling me this shit, then all of a sudden I'm going to have to be dropping money to really get my shit. No, I ain't trying to hear that. Put that shit on the website so we can read what the roofs and windows are about, and then we ain't got to do the back and forth. Put the actual fucking bill up there and let's vote.
Why don't I know what's the problem? Or let's read it. If the trustees ask for a document because they want to read it, why should they have to Google it?
Thank you. Thank you.
Why should they have to Google it? Give them the document. Real simple. So everybody in this room.
Right. Thank you, Janice, and thank you, Stella. I don't want to have to air this motherfucker out. No more outbursts.
Boom. Should want to see it on the website. Thank you.
All right. All right. I want to thank everybody for coming.
Nobody clapped at wanting to see the shit on the website. A nigga just got up there and talked about having bills and shit on the website. She was like, bet, I agree. Let's put this shit with the roofs and the windows and shit on the website.
Out, it's been a long meeting. I appreciate you. But if anybody ever need information, you guys can FOIA it. That way you don't.
No, this bitch didn't, bro. Nigga, if you need any information, nigga, you could just FOIA it. Nigga, are you... Bitch.
Bitch, are you for real?
Nah,
thanks, everybody,
nigga,
for coming out. It's been a long meeting. I appreciate you. But if anybody ever need information, you guys can FOIA it. That way you don't think anyone's up here lying. Just
I'm done, bro. Hey, nigga, you can just FOIA it, nigga. you ain't got to think nobody up here lying. I told you can pick any random fucking video. She going to say the most outrageous shit somewhere in it.
Been a long meeting. I appreciate you. But if anybody ever need information, you guys can FOIA it. That way you don't think anyone's up here lying. Just FOIA it with the clerk's office, and you're entitled to any document that we do have. You also have a VA right here, and everybody don't have a computer. Everybody do not go to a website. So whether I put it on a website, put it in a document, mail it to your home, you do get the information that we're asking the trustees to vote on. But you can FOIA anything that you think you're not getting, because we have to give it to you. So I just want to make that clear so people don't think that we're not giving out information that's for public. Thank y'all for coming out. Is there a motion to adjourn?
I motion.
Second.
Motion to second. Please call the roll.
Trustee House.
Aye.
Trustee Norwood.
I'm sorry. Aye.
Trustee Steve.
You ended the stream too early, nigga. You just altered public record, you dumbass. I can't believe this bitch just sat here and said, if you looking for any information, you can just FOIA it, nigga. I just the shit this hoe be saying, nigga. The news just went to court, nigga. Chief Lacey, this most likely gonna be your last gig, cuz. I got one more blunt and I'm gone. I gotta risk my voice. We got a big one tomorrow. We got a big one tomorrow. Yeah, they told him they couldn't print them out for you. And then the amount of motherfuckers that I've heard have literally filed FOIAs and they just literally just ignore them. And I found out because she learned that it ain't criminal. So, like, her ignoring FOIA requests, she can't get arrested for that. That's what I'm saying. Like, all the bills she's hiding, plus all the legal shit the village is going to have to pay for after all of this shit. All these different niggas are suing the village. Nigga, y'all niggas is getting ready to be South South Holland, nigga. South South Holland with y'all Almond Head Police Chief. You stay in South Holland? Nah, I stay in South South Holland. That shit that used to be Dalton? Yeah. Delgado gonna fuck around, be the first nigga to tell. Because here's one thing I do know. I do know that Delgado's not as dumb as all them niggas, right? But I don't think for one second Delgado's clean, bro. I'm sure it's all types of shit that he be... Bro, I'm sure all them niggas got some shit that they be doing because they know the mayor's stupid. How can he get out, though, Kiki? Because at this point, the moment he recuses himself, nigga, the feds might just pick him up. That's a possibility. Yeah, she don't want nobody having no records right now. She don't want, bro, once she kicked, basically when she kicked the trustees out of my viewpoint, which was the shit they was using to see like all the warrant lists and shit. Once she kicked them out of that, it was basically a wrap for everybody. And that's what makes me wonder, what the fuck did you blow the money on? Tiffany, we gonna fuck around and find out. Tiffany gonna be on American Gangster from being one of the biggest drug lords of all time. With her enforcer, Andrew Rolling 60 Crip Holmes.
I'm rolling 6-0. Anybody talk to my mayor like that? On the dead homies.
You want me to tell you something real about Stan Brown that I felt like I noticed? I'm gonna tell you some real shit, bro. And go back and watch it and see if you feel. Stan Brown, he's starting to look like a nigga that might be getting ready to roll on Tiffany. Now, obviously, he ain't gonna roll on Tiffany to nobody like the Tyrant Terminator. And that's like no disrespect to the Tyrant Terminator. That's just like, you know, it's going to be like more of a government thing. I'm going to show you what made me say it. Good night, Chiefs.
This thing right now dictate what all of these now. And
the way he's sitting here, just by himself like this, he looking like he thinking about rolling, bro. He's really starting to think about like, am I really going to go down with this shit? Look at him. Just look at this nigga. He's pondering some shit. He's in thought right now. Nigga, what if Stan Brown roll on Tiffany, bro? I just look at this nigga and I'm like, he's not looking back at the mayor, looking for instruction. He ain't turning, talking to Lacey. He's sitting there staring at the back of the room, looking at Jason House now. In like a deep trance of a thought. This nigga rolling on Tiffany. Keon, like, yo, let me get this picture. We the fuck up out of here. You know how mad Tiffany was they turned this camera around?
Trustee House, I thought y'all was leaving.
Bitch, we worse. Stop meddling.
You should come back, sit down, and handle the business, and let's finish to do what we came here to do, which is go through our agenda, but y'all give interviews. Can y'all all exit, please? Thank you. Y'all don't want to handle the business here? Say it.
Stop meddling.
Hey. Officers, clear the room. The media has to step out also. Clear the room.
Look, just let Jason know. Like, tell that nigga to call me. He'll know what it's about.
Business.
Yeah, just tell that nigga
everybody
to call me.
They can step outside. Everybody. No, just the people here, they're fine. Everybody else, media included, has to clear the room.
Yeah, just tell that nigga to call me. Please, just tell Jason to call me. Kiana, just tell that nigga to call me. I'll tell him. We'll see what he's saying. You know, I'll let him know. Yeah, it's cool. I ain't riding with the fucking mayor. This bitch about to get us locked up.
Testing.
What?
You are saying,
yeah, she about to get us locked up.
If you're not, please exit so we can.
Well, shit, I'll tell Jason.
As a body of what
I'll tell him.
In our village. This.
Let's see if Stan Brown ever checks for some instruction from Tiffany.
This is a board meeting about business, not chaos, not confusion, not disruptions. That is not what we represent here in the village of Dolton. So for those that come for the show, go outside. Because the showing is not in here. We're talking about what we've done as a community. So please, if you're going to leave, exit, and please shut the door so we can conclude our business.
Turn and look at her, Stan. Everybody else turned and looked at her for his. Yeah, he tried to test his mic. That shit ain't on. Finally. And then he don't go over to her. Hey, man, Stan might be getting ready to snitch, bro. Stand up there now. Y'all know this meeting over and we can't really do no nothing, right?
Ready? Give me 1 minute.
Stan, what are you doing, bro? Man, I wish the camera would have followed him.
Are we gonna give people time to clear out?
Yeah, this nigga Brown gonna tell, nigga. Like, he ain't fucking with her like that right now, nigga. Like, he there because he, like, he, that's the side or whatever, but.
All right.
I want to thank everybody for staying that actually came here to hear what we do in the village of Dolton. As you just saw, is chaos amongst our.
This nigga to open his binder and shit, nigga.
They come here to handle the business. They came here to do a political theater stunt, which you just saw. We didn't get through any business as it relates to us.
Look at her, Stan.
Meeting here in our village, which we're supposed to do. But yeah, everybody cry about meetings and we should have more. Why have more meetings when it's going to just be chaotic like this? Our job is to make sure we take
that care nigga of is too old for prison, bro. Business to handle. That's some real shit. We laugh. That's some real shit. A nigga Stan Brown. You see Stan Brown already got like a little limp to him and shit? Yeah. Yeah, nah. Grandbabies and shit? Nah. Mm-mm. For her? Nah.
To us, what you just saw before you. It's a shame that every time it's time to really take care of things, such as making sure payroll is paid. Because guess what? They didn't vote on paying the police, the public works, making sure your concrete is down. They did not vote on none of that. But this is the things that I face as a mayor here in the village of Dolton. And it's sad because you're seeing it with your own two eyes. I can't make this up. Y'all see that people walk out at every single board meeting. You see when we had the other.
What is she talking about when she say they walked out of every single board meeting? They didn't even walk out of this one.
They walked out when it was a $33 million issue on the table where we're supposed to win a closed session. We would have made sure we was in a better predicament if they would have stayed and made sure they took care of the business. But yet, the media don't report.
Secrets, girl.
It's good to see the media out here, but I wish you guys would come for the positive things and not the chaos and not the media show. Because
we didn't come for chaos. We came for a regular board meeting. That was the title of it.
That's all this is. I get it. We're clickbait. We're hot right now, and I get it. This is what sells papers. But I wish you guys would have came to our Easter event that we had on, what was that, Saturday? We had over 500 kids out there happy, running around, giving away baskets. It was amazing. But you should want the good stories just like you want the bad stories. But it's sad that people tell you false information with no facts, and y'all run and y'all write it. Y'all know y'all can destroy people's lives by just writing things that's not true. And then later, that person has to sit there and try to fix what you guys have broken because y'all have a national platform. So this is my outreach to the media, which I said it several times. Please, please do your research. You got
do my research? You got it.
That's your smoking ass, smoking turkey tails.
I call yourself journalism. Please research the stuff before y'all put things on your national platform and hurt people that should not be political damage because y'all want to make a story for clickbait. That's all right. And I get it. People sell their souls. I get it. You want to be.
Who sold they soul? You?
Be the hottest thing right now. I get it. You guys go and y'all get awards for who got the best story. I get it. But please stop destroying people's lives and tell.
Go back to the wide shot. I want to see Stan.
If you follow me, y'all should have paid attention to the Tiffany Henry on the Move podcast. All the things that y'all posted, which was all fake and false, I showed y'all the truth. Y'all get the same footage y'all had, but none of y'all played it. Y'all had to make it like we was lying, like I was lying. But you guys was telling lies, and that's not cool. So that is my information to you guys. So I don't know how y'all going to spin this meeting or say whatever, but show the facts. All the trustees walked out because they couldn't have their way. And that's not how government works. Government works like this, good, bad, or indifferent. We work together. We put on a good collective front for the public, and we fight in the back. But yet, people came here for a stunt, a show, because all y'all came out. I don't never see y'all come out for nothing positive like this. How y'all came out like this, come out to the next thing that we have, just like y'all out here for the bad press, which people won't clickbait. So, with that being said, we're going to get through what I've been doing as your mayor of the village of Dolton. And thank you, residents, for always supporting me, loving on me, and encouraging me.
Bitch, there ain't nobody there.
Me in your prayers, because I need that, because as you can see, I'm under attack. So, thank you.
That stud cop. We've been over this. It's the stud cop.
First, I know we was going to entertain a couple issues. The media wrote about plobos who got shut down in our village for.
Shut up! We're not hearing about plobos. Why shut?
Got a whole village because at the end you left, but yet us they're having a nice time. Watch what you work. That's not
in the town.
Go ahead, Lacey.
Go ahead.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I want to comment on.
Hold on. What was you about to say to her, Keith, when you tapped her? Bitch, we gotta go.
Just because it's traction for your network. That's not cool.
All right, Chief Lacey, go ahead.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Hey, bitch, real quick. We got to end this motherfucker or we going to prison.
I want to comment on a few things that have been developed in the town. First, I want to read off that the Dolton Police, literally, I don't probably know right after that, but obviously, officers, we're gonna shut it down. Ladies and gentlemen, for right now, for safety reasons, we are shutting the meeting down.
Well, Stan Brown definitely ain't looking at her now. Pew. Exit. Pew. Y'all see what I'm saying now, bro? Stan Brown looked like the weak link, bro. Stan Brown getting ready to tell. Nah, I think Keith might be smasher. Keith married, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, he is. 100%. I'm not mistaken. 100%. I'm not. It's Holmes, Mary? I don't know. Maybe. Her boyfriend's married. What's the difference? When it comes to evil, nothing. Not a damn thing. Man, I'm getting the fuck out of here so I can get ready for tomorrow. Get ready for this trip. Say goodnight to your boy. Dalton party tomorrow. Carl Wilson will be here. Dr. Nikita Cloud shall be here as well. And I, of course, shall be here as well. Sandy, Tiandra, Janice, Regina, Stella, Jazzy, Tag, Miss Nitra, Robert, Patricia, the motherfucking goo.
What's wrong with Angela?
Kiki. This is gonna be a fun week. But then again, I'm probably lying. God is indeed great. It's a crazy last 2 days of streaming. I'm getting some rest. I probably ain't answering no emails or nothing. I gotta get some real rest. I got some real damage I got to do this week. But then again, I'm most likely lying. Make sure you go follow Burgundy Blue Commentary. Make sure you do that. Make sure. You do that. $50,000 Christmas tree. Bitch, I know you lying.
Yo, what's going on, boys? How are you?
Yo, dab me up.
Yeah, all right, damn. What part of the city are you from?
Yo, what's up? There, brother. Hey, yeah.
What's up?
Yeah.
Right, you guys ready for this?
Take this.
Oh, all right, sick. Why don't you guys come inside?
Don't ski.
These are the guys.
I'm Octavius Gray.
And I'm Steve. Steve LeBlanc.
Set them all right. If you are, baby, I'm looking so fly. Sunset rooftop, yeah, that's nice, right? Hop in a G-Class, I know you need that. Heart racing fast like the speed of light. Is this a dream? distraction, or is it the moonlight? You want satisfaction, but only for one night. This could be real love, but you've been broken, and I just want you to see what I can be for you.
It's only 3:42.
Have a great night, Dante.
You barely.
Finding you is like a treasure. Making my heart feel this way, yeah, yeah. And I'll treat you so damn special. What you did, who you were with, I don't care about those days. When I'm with you, I won't complain. Success and heartbreaks. Yeah, you know I stay by your side. Never leave you dissatisfied. But I need you to let me know. Is this attraction? Or is it the moonlight? You want satisfaction, but only for one night. This could be real love, but you've been broken. And I just want you to see what I can be for you. 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 Baby girl, it's just one night. Yeah, baby girl, it's just one night. Oh, yeah, it's just one night. Yeah, baby girl, it's just one night.
Good night, Laura. Crushed it. God is great. I love y'all to death, bro. Rest up, kids. I shall do the same.